edition of Bridgeport Bluefish Baseball is on the air right now. It's the pregame show as the Bluefish continue their playoff run. Bridgeport taking on the Sugar Land Skeeters in a four-game series that can ultimately determine where the Bluefish might be by the end of the weekend. Hello, everyone. Perry Miles with you. The Bluefish coming off of two victories in three games against the Southern Maryland Bluecrafts, following three wins in four against the Camden River Sharks. The Bluefish have been playing well of late, winning seven of their previous 10 games, and they hope to continue with their success on the mound as Paul Seguera heads to the hill tonight. He has lost three straight decisions on the hill, and in his last three starts, no wins and three losses. Oseguera has pitched well most of the season, though. 10 wins and 6 losses, an ERA of 2.56. He'll be opposed by Jason Lane. The left-handed pitcher is 8-4 with an ERA of 2.65 in the hope that he can return to affiliated baseball as a pitcher, because he was not getting much playing time as a positional player with the Toronto Blue Jays organization before he was let go. The Bluefish and the Skeeters coming up in less than 20 minutes time. When we come back, we're going to update you on some Atlantic League news. We're going to give you the starting lineups and also look ahead as to what the Bluefish would need to do in order to make it to the postseason. Stay tuned. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
This summer, the Miller Lite Guards are saving men from making the unmanly choice of drinking light beer with less taste. How? With great-tasting Miller Lite, taste points, and thousands of prizes. So man up at tastepoints.com today. No purchase necessary. Open to legal U.S. residents 21 or older. Void in California and where prohibited. Sweepstakes begin 5-1-11 and end 7-31-11. For details, how to enter, and complete official rules, go to tastepoints.com. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Come and join the Bluefish for a playoff push in 2012. The Bluefish have great options from picnics and birthday parties to harbor club outings and sweet leases. Invite your friends, family, or coworkers out to the ballpark for an exciting night of affordable family fun. Kids celebrating a birthday party at the ballpark will get an autographed baseball, a visit from BB the Bluefish, and much, much more, including a chance to compete in the best on-field promotions Connecticut has to offer. Don't miss out on the final home games of the regular season. Book your outing with the Bluefish today. Call 203-345-4800 to schedule an unforgettable day at the ballpark at Harbor Yard during the 15th anniversary season. Or go to BridgeportBluefish.com. Bridgeport Bluefish Baseball. Get hooked.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms, the pace of the game, the mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together, just like a good team? At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community, too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community.
The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial, Inc.
This is Terry McGriff, pitching coach for the Bridgeport Bluefish, and you're listening to Perry Miles on the Bluefish broadcast.
We welcome you back to the Bluefish broadcast. Perry Miles with you as the Bluefish are about to take on the Sugar Land Skeeters. It's about 15 minutes away from first pitch. And the Bluefish yesterday, they won by a score of 5-4. At points, they had struggled. Bridgeport scoring the first one run of the game. Southern Maryland countered with a run scored in the fourth. The Bluefish scored in successive innings, three straight innings. 3-1 at that point, but Southern Maryland wound up scoring two more runs in the seventh. Bluefish countered that with two runs in the bottom half of the frame to eventually take a lead that they would not relinquish. In the ninth inning, there was a pass ball that allowed a run to score, but the Bluefish wound up winning by a count of 5-4. last night. The Bluefish and the Skeeters have faced each other so many times this year, and this is going to be the 17th matchup between the two ball clubs. The Bluefish are 7-9 against the Skeeters, including a 3-3 mark against Sugar Land at the ballpark at Harbor Yard. If they can take 3 out of 4, that would be a great accomplishment for the Bluefish. 4 out of 4 would even be better, knowing that the Bluefish may make up some ground, probably going to make up some ground, with Southern Maryland and Lancaster duking it out from Clipper Magazine Stadium in Lancaster, Pennsylvania this weekend. So the Bluefish may have a couple of games to make up. If the Bluefish are able to take 4, it's possible that they could make up at least 2 games, if not have the division lead by the end of the weekend. But it's going to take some patience, and it's going to take some fortitude from the offense today, because Paul Sierra has been really good this season. He's been great this season. He was the Liberty Division starter in the All-Star game. But the fact remains, Oseguera is not the only one who is involved in this activity. It's all about the offense, too. The Bluefish, when they won the games, they scored a minimum of 5 runs. They scored 11 in the first game. They scored 5 in the third game against Southern Maryland. And yes, they scored some runs in the middle match, but the Bluefish went up scoring the runs when they needed to. And today, it's going to be a different pitcher on the hill in Mr. Oseguera. He goes to the hill, does the left-hander, with a record of 10 wins and 6 losses, an ERA of 2.56. He has done a solid job this year, even though he has lost 3 consecutive decisions. And the Bluefish left-hander features a fastball, a changeup, and also a curveball. His fastball ranging from 85 to 88 miles per hour on the radar gun. He has done a magnificent job, and over the last few years, he's become a stable point to the Bluefish rotation. The Bluefish hoping to get another quality appearance from their southpaw. Meanwhile, he'll be opposed by Jason Lane, who owns a record of 8 wins and 4 losses, an ERA of 2.65, fastball, breaking ball, a little bit of a slider. That's what he's been throwing. He's been able to mix up the pitches and been able to retire the batters relatively effectively. Jason Lane, a former outfielder with the Houston Astros, former infielder as well, and Lane hoping to continue his way through the ranks with that record of 8-4 with a 2.64 ERA. The Bluefish and the Skeeters starting a 4-game series. Let's take a look at who the two pitchers will be facing tonight, beginning with Paul Segura's adversaries. Dominic Ramos leads off and plays shortstop. Ofelio Castro is the third baseman batting second. Dionis Cesar is the right fielder batting third. Steve Moss had 4 hits last night. He's in left field batting fourth. Josh Presley, the DH, batting fifth. Aaron Bates, the first baseman, batting sixth. Bubba Bell is in center field batting seventh. Matt Hagen occupies second base and bats eighth. Octavio Martinez rounds out the rotation for the Skeeters. The catcher was an all-star earlier this year, but his average has dropped down a little bit. And Octavio Martinez will be catching Jason Lane. The Bluefish will counter with this starting lineup. Kennard Jones leads off playing left field. Joey Gathright a little bummed up and banged up after sliding into home plate, scoring the 4th run. Maybe he's being given a day off in order for him to recuperate, but Joey Gathright is out for today. Eddie Rogers is the shortstop batting second. Prentice Redmond is in right field batting third. Willis Otañez, who's had a 14-game on-base streak over the course of his Bluefish year, he's the DH, batting fourth. Luis Lopez, the first baseman, batting fifth. James Simmons, an 11-game on-base streak heading into the day. Center fielder batting sixth. Luis Rodriguez is doing the catching, batting seventh. Luis Figueroa is the second baseman, batting eighth. And Brad Boyer rounds out the rotation for the Bluefish tonight with a record of 61 wins and 68 losses, 30-29 in half number two. Sugar Land, 60 wins and 70 losses overall, 31-29 in the second half. The tragic number for the Skeeters is 3. Any combination of 3 Sugar Land losses or 3 Lancaster victories would equate to a playoff miss by the Skeeters, because they've been eliminated from the wild card race. The Bluefish still in it at 2.5 back of Southern Maryland, and that game takes place between Southern Maryland and Lancaster at the top of the hour, the same way that this game takes place at the top of the hour. Here come the standings. Southern Maryland 33-27, 63-67 overall. The Bluefish at 30-29. So it's 2 in the loss column, 3 in the win column, and all the Bluefish need to do is finish either one half game back or one half game in front in order to force themselves to play that extra game, that 140th game, which is not right now scheduled. If they finish a game and a half back or a game and a half in front, the playoff positioning will have been determined. If it's a game and a half ahead, the Bluefish will make it to the postseason and take on their Ferry Cup rival, the Ducks, but most likely the York Revolution making it to the postseason of the wild card to start a second version of the War of the Roses between Lancaster and York for round one of the postseason, and the winners will square off for the Atlantic League Championship. The Ducks getting considerably better with their pitching staff, maybe not their offense necessarily, but their pitching staff has done a much better job of late with Brownell and Blevins being added to the mix to go with the likes of Chris Hayes and a few others, Bob Zimmerman, Randy Kiesler back, and Zimmerman's been there most of the year. The Bluefish at 30-29, Camden 25-34. They also have a tragic number. The most number of wins that Camden can have in the second half is 36. The tragic number for them is 3, any combination of 3 Southern Maryland victories and 3 Camden losses would equate to Camden being eliminated. And the Bluefish, they can get as many as 41 wins, which means their tragic number, believe it or not, for the second half is 8. Because the Blue Crabs won the second half matchup against the Bluefish 6-4 after splitting it right down the middle the first 10 games of the stanza. But the Bluefish and the Blue Crabs, if they wind up tied, there will be a play-in game rather than the other tiebreaker, which indicates about playoff position. In basketball and hockey, it's all about head-to-head matchups. In baseball, it's not. You play one more game to determine it. What can it hurt? And it could come down to that Bridgeport Southern Maryland game towards the end of the season. The Bluefish are well ahead of the Ducks at 18-40 in the second half. Meanwhile, the Revolution 34-25 in the second half, Sugar Land 30-29, and Somerset 28-31. They have been all but eliminated from postseason play. Either one win from Lancaster or one loss from Somerset, and the Patriots are not going to the playoffs for the second consecutive year for the first time in franchise history. The Bluefish against the Skeeters coming up in less than 10 minutes. We'll update you on Atlantic League scores and summaries from last night when we come back, and also provide you with the Atlantic League news that it's off the first pitch from the ballpark at Harbor Yard. This is Criminal Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com. The pivotal matchup between the Bluefish and the Skeeters coming up right after the break on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Great tasting Miller Lite, you're choosing on taste, and that's the right choice, not the wrong choice, because right is way better than wrong. You don't try to do the wrong thing. Got a wrong hand, man? I've got a cousin named Randall with clammy hands. The customer's always wrong? Well, that explains the waiter's creepy grin as I ate my toast. Two wrongs do make a wrong, so make the right choice and choose on taste. Triple hops brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. At Miller Lite, we believe that sharing a pitcher of our great-tasting draft beer will bring friends together for a good time. And good is way better than bad. No one reminisces about the bad old days. If your guess is as bad as mine, then we're a couple of idiot faces. So far, so bad? Turn that frown upside down, grumpy pants. So why have a bad time when you could have a good time with a pitcher of Miller Lite draft beer? Triple hops brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
The best way to brighten up your home is to do just that. Brighten it up. To illuminate and decorate, the exciting lighting ideas come from Valley Lighting and Home Decor. Your home becomes your showplace when you let it shine with designer lighting so distinctive it is clearly a work of art. Valley Lighting and Home Decor is set to bedazzle you with glittering crystal chandeliers and lamps. Treasures abound in unique home accents, special touches, just the right things to bring your whole decor together. Because your home is not just what's inside the four walls, brighten up your garden, your deck, and your pool area with outdoor landscape lighting. This is the season to invigorate, radiate, celebrate, rejuvenate. The brightest ideas begin here at Connecticut's largest lighting and home decor showplace. Illuminate and decorate at Valley Lighting and Home Decor on Chestnut Street in Ansonia, just a minute off Route 8, exit 16.
At Miller Lite, we believe if you're not choosing a light beer with more taste, you need to man up, not man down, because up is way better than down. You don't tell someone sad to cheer down. What's down, dog? A steamy pile and you just stepped in it. Your girlfriend's not wearing a push-down bra. It's called gravity, Isaac Nitwit. Can I be down front with you? All this down talk is bringing me down. So don't man down, man up. And choose a light beer with more taste. Triple Hops Brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Bluefish Baseball returns on the air. Perry Miles with you as the Bluefish are about to take on the Sugar Land Skeeters. Willie Upshaw makes his way to the home plate area, as does Gary Gaetti, the first-year manager for the Skeeters. Gaetti has been in baseball for many years, and in Houston, Texas, in the Houston area, he provides lessons to those down there to the young, so that way they develop into excellent baseball players. Gaetti was an excellent baseball player during his heyday back with the Twins and the Royals. A couple of World Series rings for Gaetti, and he wants to lead this team to the postseason, but it is highly unlikely that the Skeeters will make it to the playoffs. As previously mentioned, three is the tragic number for the Skeeters, as they lose three in a row, or if Lancaster wins three in a row, or a combination of the two, that equals three, the Skeeters would be out. The Bluefish tragic number is still a long way to go. It is eight, or even more than that. We mentioned that the most number of wins that Bridgeport could get at this juncture is 41. If both Bridgeport and Southern Maryland are tied at the end of the season, it would come down to that play-in game. So the tragic number, maybe nine for Bridgeport, which is still a long way to go considering that the Bluefish have 11 games to play. But the Bluefish need to win some of these games. If the Bluefish are able to win these series, these final three series, it is likely that the team will make it to the postseason. They must win three out of four against Sugarland, the two out of three against Lancaster, and two out of three against Somerset to expect to go to the postseason, because it's not as if Southern Maryland is going to roll over and die. They're going to fight. They're going to fight because they fought against the Bluefish this past week for Patrick Osborne. And now Sugarland comes in for a weekend set against the Bluefish in the hopes that they can spoil the Bluefish's hopes of making it to the postseason. Continued conversation between Gary Gaetti and Eric Diaz, who's over at third base today. Matt Beaver is behind home plate, and Manolo Alejandro is the first base umpire for today, as it is a fireworks extravaganza at the ballpark at Harbor Yard, presented by Sabret, and the Bluefish are ready for that fireworks extravaganza. More celebrations for tomorrow. It is WPLR Day, a chance to meet Chaz and AJ from the Chaz and AJ morning show on PLR, coupled with Prostate Cancer Awareness Day at the ballpark from Bridgeport, Connecticut. The Bluefish seem to be ready. They had warmed up a form. There is no batting practice today, as there was a softball game, a Porter and Chester softball game. They're a large group that came to the ballpark today to enjoy themselves on this late summer night from Bridgeport, Connecticut. It is about 7:05. Let's take a quick look at the Atlantic League news, courtesy of AtlanticLeague.com. The Somerset Patriots, they welcome their 5 millionth fan in team history on Wednesday, right before game time. Yvonne Candelaria entered the gate with the white Marcella and 3-year-old son Landon, a and became the 5 millionth fan through the ticket stub. As a result, the Combination Candelaria won season tickets to the 2013 season. A team signed bat, a Patriots jersey and iPad courtesy of BC Richard and Son, which just so happens to be a Bluefish sponsor as well. Haircuts from Supercuts, a $100 gift card, and from Buffalo Wild Wings, and a case of Coca-Cola and commemorative bottles. So plenty of the giveaway, and I'm sure the fans don't necessarily prepare for that. The Bluefish had their 3 millionth fan last year on a day when the Bluefish set team history by hitting 2 grand slams in the same inning with 2 outs. Both grand slams with 2 outs, and that 3 millionth fan for the Bluefish got tickets, I believe, for life and a few other perks courtesy of Bridgeport Bluefish and the organization. As Tim Carr is making his way towards the right side, many of the Bluefish players are camped in the dugout right now as they are waiting for the Bluefish to emerge with the home uniforms, personalized jerseys being used for this final homestand. If you'd like to have your own personalized shirt or own personalized jersey, you can call Bobby at the ticket office at extension 125. And the Bluefish players make their way, making their way out to the field as it appears that Kennard Jones is jogging out with one of the members. I believe it's the Fairfield Little League World Series Saints team. James Simmons jogging out there. And the Fairfield team being honored for their representation of the Connecticut area. They have lost to California a couple of times during the Little League World Series, only for California to fall, but a great run by Fairfield Little League World Series representatives as they will go to their respective positions. A couple of right fielders, a left fielder, center fielder. Now they also get a pound, a pump from BB.
Eddie Rogers
coming out.
Will the Thrill Lucas.
Will Lucas joins Eddie Rogers at shortstop.
At second base,
Luis Figueroa. Luis Figueroa.
Being accompanied by number 6.
Accompanied.
Michael G.
Giorgi. So those are the most of the rest of the infielders.
Luis Lopez.
And Luis Lopez
number 27.
Being brought out.
Matt, the unit Google.
Matt Buchel, I believe it was.
Luis Rodriguez, being accompanied by
Luis Rodriguez.
Biagio P. Paoletta.
Mr. Paoletta behind the plate. So that is the introduction.
And
the pitcher, Paul Segura.
Number 5,
Ryan Murray. They may have great futures in the game of baseball. And Fairfield, a couple of years back, had a representative team which made it to the Little League World Series.
And we'd like to congratulate
we are going
Fairfield
to direct
American
our
Liberty
attention now to behind home plate
and
for the singing of the national
with special
anthem.
Customized t-shirt for each player this evening. Congratulations, brought to you by Orthopedic Specialty Group. Let's hear it again for the Fairfield American Little League. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise and remove your caps for the presentation of colors, presenting colors this evening. Please welcome the Stratford Civil Air Patrol. Please remain standing for the singing of our national anthem being performed this evening by Lindsay Cam.
What so proudly we hail
Network is back. Perry Miles with you. That was a beautiful rendition of the national anthem as the fans continue to stand waiting for people representing the colors to walk off the field. Quiet moment from the left field line area, and the Skeeters go back to the dugout, as do the Bluefish, as Bridgeport and Sugar Land are going to duke it out. Game one of this four-game series. It is pivotal for the Bluefish. Sugar Land seems to be a little bit out of it right now. 8 games back of the the Lancaster Barnstormers for first place in the division, and that's what they're going to need in order to make the playoffs. The Bluefish need to surpass Southern Maryland, which is much more achievable goal, with the Bluefish winning 2 out of 3 as the Fairfield Little League was honored, given accolades and mentioned throughout the ballpark as they got to stand with their favorite Bluefish players and the respective positions that they were at. Luis Lopez, of course, at first base. Luis Figueroa at second. Eddie Rogers, short. Brad Boyer at third. Kennard Jones gets a shot in left field. James Simmons in center. Prentice Redmond in right. No Joey Gathright today, defensively or offensively. He did slide. He came up a bit hobbling, but he did stay in the game for the rest of the night. And then later on, he really began to feel it as Paulo Segura is on the hill, the left-handed tosser. This year, 10 wins and 6 losses, but he has lost each of his last 3 decisions. The Bluefish hoping to get a whole lot of confidence, a whole lot of results from Osagera the rest of the way. They're going to need it as the Bluefish and the Skeeters take place from the ballpark at Harbor Yard. The last time that these two teams met up, the Skeeters took care of business 4 out of 6. In large part, it was because of the much improved pitching by the Skeeters. Scott Kazmir's been much better of late. Jason Lane has collected a few more victories as the final warm-up toss has been released. Tim Redding's hurt, so he's not going to start in this series. Initially, he was expected to start, but it's not the case anymore. Redding's been a whole lot better, and the Bluefish are ready. So are the Skeeters. First pitch on its way. Game time, 7:13 Eastern. Last time that Osagera started, it was a whale of a performance. Last time that Jason Lane started was a whale of a performance. Last time that Osagera started, though, he did last a little bit longer than his past, but 7 innings of 5-run, 2-earned run baseball is a quality start, but the team lost by a score of 5-4 against Camden. The first pitch is a fastball. Low, 1 ball and no strikes. We are underway. Dominic Ramos, followed by Ophelio Castro and Tionis Cesar. 1, 2, and 3 in the order. Osagera delivers, and the fastball is planted high. 2 balls and no strikes. The new tradition at the ballpark at Harbor Yard is for the Bluefish fans to make noise until the first strike is thrown. Similar to the way in college basketball with the first basket, as the next toss is on the outside corner for a strike, and the fans applaud that before some of them sat down and a few more stood up. Usually they don't stand up. They usually sit down. The 2-1. swung on and lifted in the air to the right side of the infield. Luis Figueroa backpedals and makes the play. One out. It is a P4 for Ramos. At Springs, Ophidio Castro. 10 for 33 in the last two series for Castro.
Number 11.
He's been a solid hitter for much of the year. So Castro steps in with one man out. Lefty versus righty. Third baseman Boyer about halfway back between the lip of the infield and outfield grasses. As Oseguera brings the glove up, lifts the leg, and delivers. Fastball inside, one ball and no strikes. It is a gorgeous night from the ballpark at Harbor Yard. We've seen great weather all week, and the fans have reciprocated by entering the ballpark. The 1-0 is fastball outside, two balls and no strikes. Oseguera, originally from the Oakland, California area, has moved to Miami, Florida. Makes his home there, and the first time in his career has been invited to winter baseball. The 2-0 is on the outside corner, two balls and a strike. Met at least was being talked about, and if Oseguera does wind up playing winter baseball, congratulations to him. He deserves it for the year that he's had. The 2-1 is a fastball outside, three balls and a strike. This is his third season with the Bluefish. This is easily his best campaign. 10 wins and 6 losses. ERA more than a little bit less than 2 runs less than it was a year ago. 3-1 is served foul to the right. 3 balls and 2 strikes. The record may not indicate such. He may be 1 win, 1 loss worse, but 2.55 and 133 and 2/3 innings strong. Giving up less than a hit per inning. Striking out the most batters in the Atlantic League. 3-2 is a poke to the right field side. It is a base hit past Figueroa. It is a single for Castro as he gets on first base. Set up Dionis Cesar in last series for this Sugar Land team. They got key offensive contributions from the top of the order, which accelerated offensive growth and potential.
Number 14.
When it wasn't Ramos, it was Castro getting on base, and Cesar had a tendency to drive batters in. Cesar digs in, 268, 7 ribbies. Average much improved from the time that the Bluefish had faced him, even though the Bluefish were really not able to get him out too often. Cesar, a right-hand batter, played a little bit in Japan, and now is on his way to Sugar Land. He's been here about a month. Cesar waggles the bat before he lifts it up. The first pitch from Oseguera, fastball inside, one ball and no strikes. He's never played at the ballpark at Harbor Yard. Sugar Land had two series in the first half against Bridgeport in the Park City. This is the only series against the Skeeters in Bridgeport. The 1-0 from Oseguera. Ground ball to the left side, skips by the shortstop Rogers in the hole for a base hit. Back-to-back singles for Castro and Cesar as Castro shifts over to second base. It's brings Steve Moss. Finding the right spot at the right time. Moss, a 4-hit night last night. A former member of the Bluefish, his average has blossomed to 256, 42 ribbies, and also has produced 8 home runs, was with the Mexican League this season as well. His services were no longer needed in Mexico and decided on Sugar Land over Bridgeport because of proximity with his family. Family out in California. The one out toss is served foul to the left, 0-1. Felt that the plane trip would be significantly reduced in Sugar Land, which it certainly is. Only a couple hour plane flights, 2 hours compared with Bridgeport to Los Angeles, which might be a 6 hour flight. Allows for family members to visit. The 0-1 from Oseguera lifts the leg, drives forward. The fastball turned outside. One ball and one strike. Paul Oseguera. Striking out as many batters as he did. Still hoping to come up with the outs. He's already recorded one today, and he gets a second strike to Moss over the middle. One ball and two strikes. 2 hits already for the Skeeters. It's been a little bit better with the concentration focus with Oseguera, the 1-2. Curveball bounced into the ground, foul. One ball and two strikes. Oseguera has reached as high as double-A baseball, as has Moss. Moss was there a little bit longer with the Seattle Mariners. He was also in the Milwaukee Brewers organization. And Oseguera was with the Giants. Not the San Francisco Giants, but the double-A Giants in the Eastern League. The 1-2 from Oseguera, lifted foul to the right. Out of play at a ball and two strikes. A lively crowd, a vivacious crowd at the ballpark. And they're waiting for a potential strikeout. Oseguera has not been able to fool too many batters so far. The 1-2, swung on and missed. That time he fooled Moss, he got him. Strikeout for Oseguera. First one of the night as Josh Presley digs in. Lefty versus lefty. Presley has had all kinds of success in the Atlantic League stemming from his days with the Somerset Patriots. And the second time that Roger Clemens pitched, he had a bases clearing double. He has all kinds of pop in that bat. And he's been hurt much of the time. He's had a sore back, sore knees. He's had all kinds of ailments. He's been able to overcome it. Presley, one of the best hitters in the history of Atlantic League play, because of how many years and also how many hits he has produced. The two out pitch, fastball to the outside corner, 0-1. It all comes down to service in the Atlantic League. And Presley's greatest service has been providing championships for the Patriots fans. Pats have five. Presley's been a part of the majority of those. 0-1, lefty versus lefty. The next toss, fastball lays inside. One ball, one strike. Presley felt that the difference between Somerset and Sugar Land is so much, because in Sugar Land, they're drawing almost as much as the Houston Astros are right now. Season ticket holders showing up to the ballpark, and when Clemens was there, boy, it was a zoo. 1-1, line drive, base hit to left field. Charging forward is Jones. He's firing to the plate. The throw is cut off by Brad Boyer, and they have the other base runner in the rundown. Cesar is tagged out, but Castro scores in the RBI single. It is 1-0 Sugar Land at the end of a half after three base hits. The Bluefish are coming to bat in the bottom of the first when we return on BridgeportBluefish.com.
The best way to brighten up your home is to do just that.
Brighten it up. To illuminate and decorate. The exciting lighting ideas come from Valley Lighting and Home Decor. Your home becomes your showplace when you let it shine with designer lighting so distinctive it is clearly a work of art. Valley Lighting and Home Decor is set to bedazzle you with glittering crystal chandeliers and lamps. Treasures abound in unique home accents, special touches, just the right things to bring your whole decor together. Because your home is not just what's inside the four walls, brighten up your garden, your deck, and your pool area with outdoor landscape lighting. This is the season to invigorate, radiate, celebrate, rejuvenate. The brightest ideas begin here at Connecticut's largest lighting and home decor showplace. Illuminate and decorate at Valley Lighting and Home Decor on Chestnut Street in Ansonia, just a minute off Route 8, exit 16.
At Miller Lite, we know there's only one thing baseball fans love as much as great Pilsner taste, and that's rooting for the home team. Because home is way better than away. Away is not where the heart is. Bringing away the bacon? Why? Bacon is delicious. Away is where you hang your hat? You should be hung up by your underpanties. So why root for the away team when you can root for the home team? With a great Pilsner taste of Miller Lite. Triple hops brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Bluefish broadcast is back. Perry Miles with you, and it is Jason Lane on the hill. Lane has been so good over his last four starts. The last three outings, he has worked seven innings in each of those outings, picking up those victories for the Skeeters and allowing them to keep afloat in the chase for the division, which is the only matter, the only way that they can make it to the postseason. Jason Lane has a victory against Bridgeport stemming from August the 27th. And at the ballpark at Harbor Yard, he had a no decision. That came on July the 4th. Six innings of four-run baseball and six hits and two walks. 13 total innings, five earned runs allowed by Lane. But this is a much different looking Bluefish lineup right now than the one that he faced in Sugar Land last time. The first pitch floats inside to Kennard Jones. One ball and no strikes. Ofidio Castro at the lip of the infield grass at third. The 1-0 swung on and lifted in the air towards center field, angling towards center to make the play. Bubba Bell for out number one. It is an F8 for Jones as Bell was shifted towards left center. He had to veer the reverse direction towards his natural position. Eddie Rogers digs in. He has the longest active hit streak for the Bluefish at six, and he's had RBI in four consecutive games. Nice way to continue success. He has eight RBI in the last four games, which has allowed his average to stay up in the 270s. It's at 275, 67 ribbies, which is one of the best on the Bluefish team. And the one out toss from Lane is a fastball outside, one ball and no strikes. Rogers, 67 RBI, close to Luis Lopez's 68, and Prentice Redmond, who's one below that at 66. They're getting productivity from the middle of the order. The 1-0 swung on and lifted foul to the netting. One ball and one strike. Man calling the balls and the strikes today, Matt Beaver. Eric Diaz is over third base. And Manolo Alejandro is over at first base. The Bluefish just 2.5 games back. Plenty of action tonight in the Atlantic League, and we'll continuously give you updates of the Southern Maryland and Lancaster game. It means the most for the Bluefish. The 1-1 fastball outside. Two balls and one strike. More of those updates than the other teams in the Atlantic League, because this does affect the Bluefish more so than the other games. The 2-1 swung on and missed. Rogers used his back foot and wound up being in front of his front foot, a little off balance. Two balls and two strikes. Attribute much of the success to the assistance of Shea Hillenbrand, putting in a different perspective. And now Willie Upshaw helping Eddie Rogers, and Rogers executing the way that he needs to. Two balls and two strikes. Lane waits, delivers, pitch swung on and missed. Strike three, diving outside the zone. Lane has his first strikeout of the night. And three of his last four starts, at least four strikeouts for Lane. Not a power pitcher by trade. Transition from the outfield to the mound, trying to get some more playing time. And when Lane got to the Houston area for the first time in 5 years, he was excited because he was in familiar territory, but he knew that he wanted to get back to the big leagues. Left-hander lifts his leg, delivers, first pitch, fastball runs outside. One ball and no strikes. 1-0 game, RBI single, Josh Presley to left field. And Jonas Cesar was eliminated at third base. The next toss is outside, two balls and no strikes, which ended the inning. A run on three base hits, no errors, nothing across the board for the Bluefish yet. Redmond with two doubles yesterday, the 2-0. Over the middle, at the knees, Redmond leans back. He may have been a little bit disappointed by the call. Two balls and one strike, and he gets back to work. An open stance as he waggles the bat, circles the 2-1. Fastball low, three balls and one strike. Three away from Wes Bankston's record. Bankston at 39 doubles, and Redmond with 36 on the season. He's closing in on that mark. 3-1, swung on and served high in the air to deep center field. Bubba Bell moving back, he's towards the track, he's at the wall, and makes the play to the left of center at the wall for the final out of the frame. It was a long drive by Redmond, but he just missed it from here, sending it over the left center field wall, and the Bluefish do not score. It's a 1-2-3 inning. The Bluefish trail 1-0 at the end of one. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com. Come and join the Bluefish for a playoff push in 2012. The Bluefish have great options from picnics and birthday parties to harbor club outings and sweet leases. Invite your friends, family, or coworkers out to the ballpark for an exciting night of affordable family fun. Kids celebrating the birthday party at the ballpark will get an autographed baseball, a visit from BB the Bluefish, and much, much more, including a chance to compete in the best on-field promotions Connecticut has to offer. Don't miss out on the final home games of the regular season. Book your outing with the Bluefish today. Call 203-345-4800 to schedule an unforgettable day at the ballpark and Harbor Yard during the 15th anniversary season, or go to BridgeportBluefish.com. Bridgeport Bluefish Baseball. Get hooked.
A sizzling, succulent filet mignon, scrumptious salmon Florentine, savory twin grilled pork chops. Getting hungry? Your table awaits at the Park City Grill, Fairfield County's elegant new dining spot in the beautifully renovated Bridgeport Holiday Inn. Comfortable, warm, and inviting, Park City Grill offers a world-class dining experience at reasonable prices. Come to the Park City Grill, 1070 Main Street in the Bridgeport Holiday Inn. Take I-95, exit 27A to exit 2. Plenty of free, secure parking.
Bridgeport Bluefish Baseball is returning to the top of the second inning. It's 1-0 to score. One run on three base hits. No errors. Nothing across for the Bluefish yet, but still very early on, we saw the way that the Southern Maryland series unfolded. In game one, the Blue Crabs got out to a 4-0 lead before the Bluefish stormed right back, scoring 11 times, six straight innings with runs, including that five spot in the second to wipe out that lead and give the Bluefish its first advantage. It's a little bit less than that. It's only 1-0. And so Oseguera stands tall towards the middle of the rubber. The first pitch released over the middle for a strike, going one. Aaron Bates, Bubba Bell, and Matt Hagen, 6, 7, and 8 in the order for the Skeeters. The 0-1. Fastball inside, one ball and one strike. Lefty against righty today. Bates, a former member of the Memphis Redbirds. Next toss, fastball away, two balls and one strike. The interesting part was Bates in 2011 was part of the Rochester Red Wings. He was signed after being released by the Minnesota Twins organization, and Brock Peterson reports to the Bluefish in June of 2011. Peterson goes to Memphis, and Bates is the one in the Atlantic League this time. The pitch is served foul to the right. Two balls and two strikes. Bates' confidence seems to be a little bit off, though. His batting average a little bit further down than what most expected him to produce. 231. He has 12 extra base hits in 45 games, and has driven in 23 this season. Two balls and two strikes. Oseguera deals a fastball, stays high, three balls and two strikes. It's amazing to see how the carousel works between Bates and Peterson, Peterson and Bates. It does happen. Think about the way that Tommy Everidge and Wes Bankston, they were in the Oakland organization nearly the same time. As the 3-2 is served deep to right field, Prentice Redmond angles towards the track and makes the catch in front of the Mackman insurance sign for out number one. Deep drive to right, but Aaron Bates, there's not much room for error when it comes down to hitting. You better hit it square or it's not going out of the yard, and Redmond has plenty of speed in right field to be able to catch up with the baseball. In Constellation Field, for those of you out there who have never been there, it is 348 feet down the right field line. That ball would have easily stayed in the park at that venue. Here is Bubba Bell, the center fielder and an all-star, takes the first pitch, strike down the middle, nothing and one. Bell at 288, not much power in terms of home runs or triples, but has 33 doubles. Not bad. 0-1, lifted foul, inside out, Pope, nothing in two. Affiliated experience from Bubba Bell, like many of the players in this league. Not too many lifetime indie players like Kyle Zaleski on the Bluefish. The 0-2, fastball inside, one ball and two strikes. And Bubba Bell, 1982, so he's 29 years old. He'll be 30 in October. 1-2, curveball, picked up in the dirt by Machete. Two balls and two strikes. Rodriguez has been behind the plate for each of the last three games. Angel Flores' last time behind the plate was one of the two games in the doubleheader against Camden on Monday, a doubleheader sweep, which was imperative for the Bluefish to set the stage for that Blue Crab series. The 2-2 swung on, line drive over the leaping Rogers into left field for a base hit as Kennard Jones flips the ball into the second baseman, Luis Figueroa. It's a one-out single. Four hits for the Skeeters through the first seven batters that have been up at the plate against Oseguera as Matt Hagen digs in. Oseguera was dynamite against the Skeeters the first five innings or so before Oseguera had his franchise record scoreless inning stretch snapped at 24 and one-third innings. 24 and a third innings when an unearned run scored in the fourth, and then 26 and a third without allowing an earned run as the pitch floats outside. One ball and no strikes. Oseguera set a franchise record passing by Miguel Saladin, 23 and two-thirds scoreless before he was scored upon. The 1-0, fastball low, two balls and no strikes. Matt Hagen, Josh Presley joined from Somerset from several successful ball clubs. Last year was not a very successful campaign for Somerset, 49 and 74 on the field. Throw to first from Oseguera, not in time. 2-0 coming up from the southpaw. Hagen and Presley closing in to the end of their careers. Presley, even if he said that he might not be coming back after this year, the throw to first, swipe tag, not in time. This year he was only playing because he was going to be close to his family for half the season. The other half, he would have to take plane flights to the East Coast, similar to the way that he had in AAA baseball and the way that big leaguers would in major leagues. 3-0, fastball outside, ball four, and Hagen walks. Oseguera had retired the first batter in the first inning before a couple of runners reached on a single and a single. This time it's a single to walk with one man out after Bates had been retired to lead off. Octavio Martinez digs in. The Skeeters have their royal blue uniforms with the Skeeter yellow. It's almost like the Cal Golden Bear yellow on the back with the name, the number in black.
Catcher, number 16, Octavio Martinez.
It is an interesting uniform. The logo in front, the Skeeters across the jersey in calligraphy. One man out, the Bluefish in their home whites. The one out deliveries over the outside corner, nothing in one. The outfield is playing straight away. Not expecting Martinez to angle the ball towards left center or right center. 0-1 release, a chopper to the third base side. Boyer with the nice scoop up, the throw to second gets the trailing runner in Matt Hagen. So the Bluefish are able to retire one on a fielder's choice, 5-4. Figueroa cruised around the bag and almost pulled the neighborhood playoff. Actually tapped the bag with the cleat. Bubba Bell moves over to third base. Octavio Martinez is safe at first as Dominic Ramos steps forward. Two home runs and six RBI in his last series against the Bluefish. 271 on the season with the Skeeters. 12 and 30 for Ramos, the two out offering. Flattens high, one ball and no strikes. Third baseman Brad Boyer hovering towards third before he backs off of it near the cutoff at the grass. The 1-0 from Oseguera. Line drive, one hop scoop by Boyer. He throws to first in time, and that retires the side. The Bluefish escape a jam. Runners at first and third with two men out. No runs come across. One base hit, the end of an inning and a half. It's 1-0, Skeeters on top. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
The YP.com website is your local search engine. If you're looking for a good restaurant, it can help you find the right one nearby with ratings and reviews. Or if your car breaks down, you can use the YP app to find the closest repair shop. Or maybe you're just looking for something to do on a Friday night. Well, it has great local coupons for all sorts of things in your area. No matter what, when, or where, if you're looking for something, YP Local Search can help you find it. So go to YP.com or download the app to search local, find local, and save local.
The Gear Shop at the ballpark at Harbor Yard is your one-stop shop for everything Bluefish. Take a break from the action and check out all your Bluefish souvenir favorites. From men's and women's t-shirts and a wide selection of home, road, and other trendy hats, to Fear the Fin rally towels, team photos, and commemorative baseballs. The Gear Shop has it all. Don't forget about our kids' wear section, game-worn jerseys, even your own stuffed BB the Bluefish, and more. The Bluefish Gear Shop is located on the third base side of the concourse level at the ballpark at Harbor Yard and is open on game days. Come and browse all your favorite Bluefish apparel from an hour before the first pitch until the final out is made. Can't make it to the ballpark on game day but still want to support Fairfield County's only professional baseball team? Then check out the new Bluefish online store at BridgeportBluefish.com or call 203-345-4800 to schedule an appointment. The Bluefish Gear Shop. Perfect gifts for all ages and all sizes. Located at the ballpark at Harbor Yard, 500 Main Street, Bridgeport, Connecticut.
Bridgeport Bluefish Baseball is back for the second inning. The bottom of the second is Willis Otañez. Steps forward, he's followed by Luis Lopez and James Simmons, 4, 5, and 6 in the order. Otañez has done a solid job being the power source for the Bluefish. 5 homers and 15 RBI in his stint with the team. It's a little more than a month. Otañez was a member of the Bluefish from 02 to 07. The pitch is served, fouled down the right side, nothing in one. First baseman Aaron Bates tried to track it down towards the warning track, but it fell into the reserved section on the upper right portion of the screen, far right. We thank everybody for tuning into the Bluefish Broadcast Network today. Perry Miles with you. No balls in one strike. Lane deals, and the fastball travels to the inside corner, nothing in two. Steve Moss out in left field, Bubba Bell in center, and Dionis Sessa. In right, Ophelio Castro's at third base, Dominic Ramos at short, Matt Hagen's at second, Aaron Bates at first. Corner infielders playing back. Next toss, slap foul as Otañez stays alive. Martinez behind the plate. You may see Manny Mejia get a chance or two opportunities in this series to catch. One of them will most certainly come tomorrow in a double dip. 0-2, launch foul down the right field line. As Bates stares at it, going into the concourse between the field box seats and the reserved section. And for those of you out there who are definitely interested in Bluefish game, you can come to the ballpark at Harbor Yard. This weekend set, tonight, fireworks extravaganza. 7:05 first pitch, 6:05 for the gates opening tonight. As the next one is in there, strike three, Otañez goes down. One away on the second strikeout of the night. Fireworks extravaganza following the conclusion of this ball game. Saturday is Prostate Cancer Awareness Day and also WPLR Day. Chaz and AJ in the morning. Chaz and AJ will be here. You'll be able to meet up with them. And Sunday is All in Family Fun Sunday. kids autograph session, and kids run the bases to close out the weekend. And the Bluefish have a three-game series after that against the Lancaster Barnstormers at their home ballpark. The one-out toss is lifted in the air to shallow left center field. Driving forward to make the play is Bubba Bell as he called off the shortstop, Dominic Ramos, at the last moment. It's a P8 on the score sheet, two away for James Simmons. Took a quick amount of time. Lopez swung first pitch, anticipating fastball, and got off speed from Lane. That's why the cat and mouse game is so difficult for the batter to win. Batter cannot think. All the batter must do is react. Hall of Fame batters fail 70% of the time at the plate. Simmons digs in. Taps the inside corner a couple of times before he sets to out toss. Fastball. Maybe a tad high, one ball and no strikes. Simmons, during his 11-game on-base streak, batting .417. He has earned five extra base hits during that part. There's the 1-0. Drifts outside, two balls and no strikes. Continuous updates from across the Atlantic League, including Southern Maryland and Lancaster. The 2-0 swung on and missed. Two balls and one strike on what appeared to be a sinking fastball. Southern Maryland, Lancaster scoreless in the top of the third inning from Clipper. Other scores, the Ducks 2 and the River Sharks nothing, top of the third. Next toss, line drive, base hit, 12 game on base streak. The right fielder, Deona Cesar, flips it into Hagen. Relay throw to second.
Baseball Hall of Famer James O'Rourke.
It is a two-out base hit, setting up Louis Rodriguez.
National League history.
Catcher has produced nine home runs this year. Brought in 42 runners. As many as six RBI in a game this year. In asking him about his prowess that day, he said he's driven in six, seven, eight runs in a game before. But it's always a great thing to help contribute the team to winning. Next toss flipped. Foul to the upper deck, 0-1. Jason Lane, not fearful of anything. He experimented with pitching after his hitting seemed to go in a big funk. His career seemed to be spiraling downward. The 0-1, a high drive down the right field line, but it shoots towards the high hole area. Kicks go. No balls and two strikes. One 4-0 to 0-1-0. A lone run coming in an RBI single by Josh Presley of the road team. Simmons has only been caught stealing once and happened last game or two. And that 0-2 drifts outside, one ball and two strikes. You know that Lane is going to be concerned with Simmons. 12 stolen bases out of 13 attempts. The 1-2 lunging at it. Rodriguez, he stays alive. A ball and two strikes. Tomorrow's game, 105. Game one. And that should feature Gilbert De La Vara for the Bluefish. Gilbert De La Vara versus Scott Kazmir. The 1-2, jam shot to the netting. One ball and two strikes. Game two, Brad Thompson against TBA. The expectation was Kelvin Villa would head to the hill because of his experience in the starting rotation. At one point, Villa was a bullpen guy. He's been switching between bullpen and starting rotation. Villa just looking for any opportunity. The 1-2, another pitch spoiled out of play to the right side as Octavio Martinez ran after it on a diagonal from home plate towards the Bluefish batter's box, or rather the on-deck circle. One ball and two strikes. Light fixtures are on. Slight amount of wind is indicated by the American flag. Slight breeze from left to right. Runner goes, the 1-2, swung on and poked in the air towards shallow center field. The shortstop, Ramos, makes the catch about 10 feet beyond the lip of the outfield grass for the final out of the frame. The Bluefish pick up a hit, but cannot score. At the end of two, it's 1-0 Sugarland. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Hey kids, it's not too late to join BB and all of his friends by becoming a member of the Bluefish Snappers Club. The Snappers Club is the newest club for all of the biggest or littlest Bluefish fans. As a member of the Snappers Club, you'll not only get free entrance on Snappers Club Day, but you'll also get a membership card to show all of your friends, plus a special t-shirt that will tell everyone you're a member of the club. After each Sunday home game, Baseball Bunch members will also be invited onto the field to run the bases, just like the Bluefish do. You'll even receive a newsletter that will fill you in on all of your favorite Bluefish players, along with all the news that BB Snappers Club has to offer. To join the coolest club around, call 203-345-4800 or go to BridgeportBluefish.com/kids/snappers to become a member of BB's Snappers Club.
The YP.com website is your local search engine. If you're looking for a good restaurant, it can help you find the right one nearby with ratings and reviews. Or if your car breaks down, you can use the YP app to find the closest repair shop. Or maybe you're just looking for something to do on a Friday night. Well, it has great local coupons for all sorts of things in your area. No matter what, when, or where, if you're looking for something, YP Local Search can help you find it. So go to YP.com or download the app to search local, find local, and save local.
Third inning down by a run, it's 1-0. Luis Rodriguez had popped down to the shortstop Ramos to end any possible threat. James Simmons picked up the first Bluefish hit. There have been hits by Castro, Cesar, Presley, and Bubba Bell. Five total base runners given up by Oseguera with that one run scoring in the first inning of Josh Presley's RBI single. And Brad Boyer is in at the lip of the infield grass, possibly expecting a bunt as Ophelio Castro digs in. He slaps at it foul down the right side, nothing and one. Castro one for one with a single and a run scored. Was an all-star this year. He's at 296 entering today. Average will continue to move up if he's able to continue with the success hitting the baseball. The 0-1 is outside, one ball and one strike. Bluefish have Oseguera today, Gilbert Del Var, Brad Thompson tomorrow. Jonah Bayless is expected for the final game of the series. The 1-1 is swung on and missed, a ball and two strikes against Lane, Kazmir, TBA, and Michael Nix, a guy that the Bluefish have had all kinds of problems dealing with, not just with the Skeeters, but with the York Revolution and the Newark Bears, but even before that. The 1-2. Fastball cruises outside just low. Two balls and two strikes. Some of the fans disgruntled about the call, but Oseguera continuing to work. Southpaw holds the glove of the belt. Next pitch swung on and lifted in the air to shallow center field. It drops in for a base hit. Behind Luis Figueroa in front of James Simmons. A big turn by Castro. Figueroa delivers to Eddie Rogers. It is a leadoff single. He's 2-for-2, Castro is. Cesar digs in. Plenty of affiliate experience from Cesar.
Which is why Deonis Cesar.
Skeeters wanted him. Productive bat. Some power in it. Even though he's not shown a propensity to provide that kind of power in that ballpark. The first pitch swung on and lifted into deep left center field. James Simmons on a dead sprint, catches up with the baseball and makes the catch up against the wall. It was right in front of the Aquarian sign and to the left of that. It was a long drive. Cesar must have just missed the baseball. Either that or the ball is not carrying as well as I initially thought towards left center.
Left fielder number 19, Steve Moss.
For Cesar, Steve Moss steps up. Oseguera giving up quite a few hits in the early going. Sugarland just pushing across one run, and this was their main problem throughout the first two-thirds of the season, scoring runs. They've done a little bit more of late. The one-out toss, foot tie, one ball and no strikes. Osaga's fastball is sneaky quick. It's 85 to 88, but when he sets it up with that curveball changeup inside and then throws that fastball outside, gets several batters to swing at it, throw to first, not in time. Looks like it's going 92, 93. Radar gun only shows 87, 88 at best. 1-0 from Oseguera. Slide step and the fastball lands outside. Two balls and no strikes. One man out in the frame. 1-5-0, 0-1-0. The 2-0, fastball upstairs. Three balls and no strikes. With the Bluefish, Steve Moss got on base at one time, 35 consecutive games. This year, he's had a 9-game hit streak with the Skeeters and a 12-game hit streak with the squad. The 12, obviously, coming in July, was trying to get through as the pitch is upstairs, ball four. Moss takes his base. Runners at first and second with one man out for Josh Presley. He was trying to get used to the improved pitching in this league, and Willie Upshaw does not see much improved pitching tonight. He's going to the mound, hoping to settle down Oseguera. Talk about the situation. Runners at first and second. Castro has some speed, and Moss certainly has some speed. We've seen his base running and his defense on display at the ballpark at RBR, but Josh Presley is a double play candidate. Upshaw has to implement the strategy right now. We'll see what he decides to go with. Perhaps the shortstop, Eddie Rogers, will angle a little bit more towards third with Figueroa covering up some of the real estate up the middle. Eddie Rogers, Figueroa, Lopez all break out of position. Perhaps out of potential double play scenario. There are not too many double plays turned each game.
Now batting designated hitter.
This year it's between Bluefish and the Bluefish's adversaries. It's been about three double plays a game. Less than one for the Bluefish in about one and a half. So you approximate that in about 2.5 to 3 DPs per game. The one out delivery. Fastball down the middle, 0-1. Osiera's pitch count getting a little bit up there. More than 50 pitches on the day for Oseguera. You have one out in the third. The 0-1. Swung on and missed. Presley took a big cut. Almost like a windmill. Came up with no air. And no flight with the baseball. No balls and two strikes. Lefty against lefty. Oseguera and Presley. Next toss, sliced foul. It was a better swing by Presley because he kept his front shoulder square, did not open up much. If he did, he was able to see the ball from Oseguera's hand to the point it crossed the plate. No balls and two strikes. Shortstop Rogers bluffs going towards second before backpedaling. Timeout is called. Oseguera may have taken a bit too much of that. We thank everybody for tuning in on BridgeportBluefish.com. If you have any questions, comments, or concerns about the Bluefish broadcast, you can go to the website, BridgeportBluefish.com. You can send me an email, or you can post it on YouTube. The 0-2. Chopped on the ground towards third. Boyer backpedals, gets it on the back of the infield grass. The throw is not in time as Lopez had to come off the first base bag. The bases are loaded on an infield single as Presley hustled down the line. With one away, it's Aaron Bates. So Skeeters have the bases chucked. One run on six base hits, and you wonder if the Bluefish, not to say that they don't have any confidence in their starting pitcher, Oseguera has been great much of the year. You wonder if and when the Bluefish southpaw, or maybe there will be bullpen activity, the one-out toss swung on and fouled off to the screen, nothing and one. The feel of this game is such that Upshaw wants to control the flow of the offense from Sugar Land because of the way that they've been able to jump out on the Bluefish. Same way with Southern Maryland. Seems that they're identical teams. Swinging early in counts, especially early in the game, holding back a little bit later as soon as the Bluefish get acclimated with the way that Sugar Land or Southern Maryland's able to swing the stick. The 0-1 is inside on a fastball. One ball and one strike. Third baseman Boyer backs up. Aaron Bates, AAA experience in his career out of Manhattan, New York. 1-1, foul, tipped into the glove. One ball and two strikes. New York City product, attended North Carolina State and San Jose State for baseball. Powerful hitter. Lefty versus righty. The 1-2 from Oseguera. Fastball stays high. Two balls, two strikes. It's very difficult sometimes to adjust the swing, especially when the swing provides so much confidence and so much energy. First time that the ball players fails. Pitch is grounded off the leg of Oseguera to the left side of the infield and scoots to the grass. Eddie Rogers fields in the outfield. It's going to probably be ruled a single. That's what it is. A single on a kick save by Oseguera. One run scores as Castro comes to the plate. It is a 2-0 lead. Moss over to third. Presley moves to second. Springs Bubba Bell. And already offense early.
Center fielder, number 10,
Sugarland taking charge. Bases are loaded. Lefty, lefty. Oseguera waits and fires. Pitch dribbled to the right side. Foul. Nothing in one. The Bluefish cannot afford to get any further behind. Jason Lane has given up one hit through the first two innings, yes. And the Bluefish, they have been able to come back against some of the elite pitchers, the likes of Nick Green and Dan Reichert, the 0-1, lifted in the air down the left field line. Kennard Jones sprinting over, he has room. Can he make the catch? Did he? No, he did not. It's a foul ball. He went right against the netting. Nearly went into the picnic area. Just a long strike, nothing in two.
I want to hear you. Come on, let's go.
No balls and two strikes with one man out. Two 7-0, 1-0. Lefty against lefty. Oseguera settles at about the 0-2. Swung on and missed. Oseguera, outstanding pitch. Second out of the frame. Matt Hagen digs in. Hagen a walk. It is vital that the Bluefish escape this jam unscathed.
Second baseman will be 23, Matt Hagen.
Hagen a walk. He's driven in 24 in 2012. A 239 clip entering tonight. The first pitch, curveball. Squeezes in there for a strike, 0-1. The left fielder, Kennard Jones. Center fielder, James Simmons, playing deep, 0-1. Fastball sent outside, 1-1. Less than an hour into the ball game, Skeeters feel like they escaped a bullet last night. They held on to win 11-9. Tying run was at the plate for the Patriots. It was 11-6 to start the inning. Next toss is lifted in the air to right field. Prentice Redmond jogs in and makes the play for the final out of the frame. The Bluefish escape with just one run scoring for Sugar Land. Three base hits and the bases left loaded. At the end of 2.5, it is 2-0, Sugar Land on top. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Don't check your rest or follow up with your supervisor, because Miller Time has nothing to do with when and everything to do with who.
What's up, Tommy?
Miller Lite is brewed for the guys you're proud to call your brothers, who'll always talk you out of getting that faux hawk and never talk.
Nice.
During your backswing. And when you've got your brothers and the light beer that tastes like a beer should,
yeah.
It's not just a good time, it's Miller Time.
Great beer, great responsibility. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms, the pace of the game, the mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together, just like a good team? At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community, by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community.
The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial Inc.
Bluefish Baseball is back. Perry Miles with you as the Bluefish are now trailing 2-0, but could have been a whole lot worse for the Bluefish as the first pitch is a fastball down the middle, 0-1. Fastball right down Broadway. The fans filling up the ballpark at Harbor Yard on this September night. A beautiful one. The 0-1 ground ball towards the middle. The shortstop Ramos throws to first as he shuffled to his left, one away in the bottom of the third. So Figueroa is 0-4-1, entered today, 273 on the campaign. 6-3 springs Brad Boyer to the dish. Boyer has been one of the most improved players on the Bluefish squad. Done a great job with them. There's one man out.
Brad Boyer.
Third baseman travels forward. Lefty against lefty. Third baseman Ofelio Castro towards the lip of the infield. Grass Boyer bounces one into the ground. Foul to the right side. 0-1. Former Lancaster Barnstormer was traded a little more than a month ago. Boyer stays in there. And he's provided the Bluefish with a boost offensively, defensively with his versatility. The next pitch is a heater high. One ball, one strike. And quickly, Lane tries to release another one. The count, two balls and one strike on a fastball. So Lane tried to quick pitch as he received the sign. He's on the third base side of the rubber. The 2-1, fastball to the outside corner, two balls and two strikes. Boyer has not found much success against lefties this season, just three hits against the left-handers for the most part. 2-2, fastball outside, 3 balls and 2 strikes. Bernard Jones is the last batter due up in this frame. You can hear the boisterous fans out there continuing to support the Bluefish team. And Bridgeport has yet to put together a sustained rally as the 3-2 is lofted into the air to shallow left center field. Ramos on the move. It dunks in for Mason. Boyer is at first base as Bell delivers the ball in, or rather, Ramos delivers the ball in. Ramos and Bell converge in that imaginary triangle, the point where the three fielders meet, left fielder Moss, Bubba Bell in center, and Ramos in short. So Boyer is at first base for Kennard Jones. Jones a fly ball to center in his first at bat. An F8. Lefty on lefty again. So Lane goes, Boyer goes. The pitch is skied in the air at the home plate area. Octavio Martinez in foul ground makes the catch, and there is no throw to first because Boyer, even though he'd gone all the way to second base, he was told to rush back to first, and he did. Cats PF2 for Jones. Eddie Rogers sets up.
Number 24, Eddie Rogers.
It was supposed to be a hit and run. And Jones hit it straight up in the air. Light fixtures are on. Left center, right field. For those of you out there for the first time tuning in, 325 down the line, 365 to the absent, 405 to center field. Ballpark at Harbor Yard has been in existence since 1998 as the next pitch is fouled off. No balls and one strike. Makes it one of two teams in the Atlantic League remaining from the original squads. The Bluefish and the Patriots. No balls and one strike. Rogers an 0 for 1 day. He represents the tying run, the 0-1. Fastball leans low, 1 ball and 1 strike. Eddie Rogers gets to the plate. He knows how to drop that bat head down. He did the other day, drive a home run, which extended his RBI stretch as the 1-1 is lofted foul to the left. 1 ball and 2 strikes into the upper deck. You can hear the fans with a surge of noise. They are anxious. They are tense. And in a sense, screaming because they see a souvenir. They see a baseball. They come home with one by going to the ballpark in every yard and watching the Bluefish play. 1-2 throw to first, not in time. Corner outfielder Moss playing a little bit deeper than he normally does. Not terribly deep. The 1-2 throw to first, not in time. Center fielder Bubba Bell is much more shallow towards right center field for the captain of the outfield. And the corner outfielder, Tionis Cesar, is more shallow than Steve Moss's position. The 1-2, swung on and missed. Rogers goes down, and that ends the inning. The Bluefish, they do not score.
Right,
one base hit, one runner left on. End of three. Bridgeport trails 2-0. Stay tuned. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com. Here is Terry McGriff. He talked about winter baseball, and I asked him whether or not the bench coach was thinking about possibly becoming a manager or a bench coach in winter baseball. Here's what he had to say.
I have thought about it recently, but what has helped me out a lot is just being around different managers. And because as a player, you think that there's only one way to manage. Or as a player, you're thinking that the manager, the guy that's managing your team, maybe doesn't have an idea or maybe he does. But, you know, what helped me was just being around different managers and seeing how they manage the team. So I can just get a little bit from each manager, and if I get a chance to manage one day, then you just implement, and you know, you just take what you've learned from people and you just apply it, because you know, I don't know it all, and I'm pretty sure a lot of managers will tell you, you're only as good as your horses anyway. You know, you're only as good as the guys you have. So, you know, managing, I've been thinking about it recently, but I really enjoy myself here with Willie, and he's one of the best.
Mike Piazza talks about the Baseball Hall of Fame.
It just connects you with the history of the game and the tradition of this game and how important this game is to the fabric of society. It's something I used to bond with my father, and I will always, and I love to sort of teach my kids the history of baseball.
Preserving history, honoring excellence, connecting generations. Connect with Cooperstown at baseballhall.org.
Bluefish and the Skeeters from the ballpark at Harbor Yard. Paul Segura waits. The first pitch is lifted foul. No balls and one strike. He went to the backstop and green back to the grass. 2-7-0 to 0-2-0. Leadoff batter, Octavio Martinez, followed by Dominic Ramos and Ofelio Castro. It is the fourth. It's almost trivia time from the ballpark. As the next toss is a line drive hit on one hop by the catcher, and Figueroa throws the first in time for out number one. It's a 4-3. There's a humpback line drive to Figueroa. Shoveled a couple of one step, maybe two steps to his left side, was able to corral. Dominic Ramos digs in. Ramos is 0-2, top of the order. After going 11 for 32 in the last two series, so he had been performing quite well. Four doubles, four runs in each of those series, rather in those two series combined. The one out toss, fastball inside, one ball and no strikes. Great night for baseball. Temperatures 70 degrees or slightly more than 70. Next fastball trained outside, two balls and no strikes. And you also have fans out, hear the noises in the background, many people talking about the game, chatting about everything that's taking place. The 2-0 is a fastball to the inside corner, 2-1. I expect more great weather from the Park City over the course of the weekend. There's a double dip tomorrow, 2-7s, the 2-1. Slap foul to the right. Two balls and two strikes. And after that, there will be plenty of more great days ahead. The next chance of rain comes on Tuesday, possibly against the Barnstormers, and then more showers expected on Wednesday. The 2-2, a high floating pop up to the right side of the outfield where Luis Figueroa, the second baseman, makes the catch. Two outs in the fourth. Trivia time on BridgeportBluefish.com. Which member of the Bluefish has the most hits against the Skeeters this season? Which member of the Bluefish has the most hits against the Skeeters this season? You can send me an email, perrym86@gmail.com. You can post your answer on the YouTube page as well.
Third base number 11, Ofelio Castro.
Here comes Ofelio Castro. Two men out, delivery, spike foul down the right field line. It's sent screaming towards the Ohio De Niro kids' goal. Nothing in one. Third baseman Boyer playing in. Expecting a positive one from Castro, the 0-1. Jam shot sent towards right center field. It drops in for a base hit. Castro is on base for the third time tonight. Three singles. Nobody can seem to get him out. That time more of a jam shot than a line drive. Cesar steps forward. A single and a fly ball to center. Cesar touches the plate a couple of times with his bat before he makes his way through. Slightly open stance, first pitch, big pop and a foul to the right side. No near the upper deck. Nothing in one. Runner at first base is Ophelio Castro. He's got some speed, which is why Osigaris checking on him. Castro on the year, 4 stolen bases and caught one time. Large sample size, 114 games. Next fastball outside the throw to first had to be scooped up by Lopez off the first base bag towards the lip of the infield grass. 1-1. The Southern Maryland-Lancaster series is expected to be a major pitcher's duel. And right now, the Blue Crabs lead the Barnstormers 2-0 in the top of the fourth. Same score that the Skeeters lead the Bluefish by. York 4, Somerset 2 in the bottom of the sixth. A 1-1. Floater scooped up in the dirt, 2-1.
Any quarter and Chester
Long Island 3, Camden
up.
Nothing in top of the fifth. From FPH Ballpark.
Please the quarter and Chester Kiosk on the third base side of the convoy at this time.
Lots of action today, but Osigaris has thrown so many pitches early on. Two outs in the fourth, closing in on 80. He's at 77 with 46 of those in the zone. Timeout is called. 2 balls and 1 strike. The inaugural season of Skeeters baseball was great. Have the highest attendance in the league. The 2-1 is lofted foul to the upper deck. 2 balls and 2 strikes. And we'll see if the Skeeters are able to continue with their success. They draw major weekend crowds. They had the highest total in the weekend in Atlantic League history with the second Roger Clemens game featured. The Ducks in town. It was more than 8,500, almost 8,600 fans in that one game. The 2-2 throw to first, not in time. And it broke the 3-day weekend attendance record set by the Patriots earlier in the year at 22-2. Next pitch, a high surging fly towards left center field, but it's going to die in James Simmons' glove for the final out of the frame. Fly ball to center, that ends any other threat. The Bluefish give up one hit to Castro, but he's stranded at first base. End of 3.5, the Bluefish are down 2-0. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
The YP.com website is your local search engine. If you're looking for a good restaurant, it can help you find the right one nearby with ratings and reviews. Or if your car breaks down, you can use the YP app to find the closest repair shop. Or maybe you're just looking for something to do on a Friday night. Well, it has great local coupons for all sorts of things in your area. No matter what, when, or where, if you're looking for something, YP Local Search can help you find it. So go to YP.com or download the app to search local, find local, and save local.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms, the pace of the game, the mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together, just like a good team? At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community, too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community.
The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial, Inc.
Late in the gear shop right now.
It is Jason Lane for his fourth inning of work. 2 runs on 8 base hits, no errors, no runs. 2 base hits and no errors. with Prentice Redmond stepping up second time around for Redmond. He was unsuccessful his first time. He smacked a fly ball to deepest part of the park to the left of center, and Bubba Bell caught up with baseball. The first pitch is a curveball, maybe a tad high, maybe a tad outside, one ball and no strikes. Redmond, Otañez, and Lopez. 3-4-5, the 1-0. Fastball bends upstairs. Two balls and no strikes. The Skeeters infield playing deep, and the outfield seem to be playing deeper. The 2-0 runs to the outside edge. 2-1. The expectation is for Prentice Redmond to hit a double. It's what he's done all year. They're trying to prevent those doubles. The 2-1. Swung on and lifted. Deep left field. Going back is Moss. He's at the track. He's at the wall. That ball is gone. So low shot. Prentice Redmond. He ripped it to left field. And the Bluefish are within a run. It's 2-1. You can hear the fans erupt in jubilation, and now several of the fans are dancing after the fact as Redmond rifled it over the wall. It is home run number 17 in RBI 67 as the Bluefish closed the gap to within a run. Redmond felt comfortable the first at bat as Otañez stares at ball one high. One ball, no strikes. The first at bat, he just missed the baseball as it was up in the zone. Second one, torched it well over the wall. Believe it, went into the netting. Go 1-0. Otañez, well out in front. One ball and one strike. Willis Otañez hoping to back it up. Back-to-back shots would tie the game. It's 2-1 right now in the bottom of the fourth, the 1-1. Inside-out approach off the netting, a ball and two strikes. This is one of the toughest pitchers that the Bluefish will have to face the entire series. This is the best thrower that the Skeeters have. He was the pitcher of the month in July. 1-2, swung on and smoked into left center field. It's in the gap for a base hit as it goes towards the wall. Otañez goes to second. And he's standing up there with a no-out double. Runner in scoring position for Luis Lopez. That was a boomer of a shot. Otañez took a pitch middle up and smoked it like salmon. Boy, that's going to make me hungry. I'm sure Lopez is hungry for another hit. 2-8-0 to 1-4-0. Castro off the third base bag. Aaron Bates is well off the first base bag. Timeout called with Martinez having a discussion with Jason Lane not to feel a bit trapped or to fall into the Bluefish trap. A home run, two straight extra base hits. The first baseman for Bridgeport is 0-for-1. He sent a fly ball to center. His first time up, the next toss stroked out of play to the right, nothing and one. Lane initially showed such confidence, the body language indicative of that. He's slouching slightly over as he brings the ball to the belt. Next toss, 0-1 is over the middle, nothing and two. His body language seems to have changed after Redmond and Otañez gave him a wake-up call. Lane hoping to not sleep right through the alarm. The 0-2 from the lefty to the righty. Pitch, ground ball to the left side. Fielding Ramos on the move. He throws to first in time, and Otañez, because he was scampering to third, made it there. Less than two outs, the tying run 90 feet away on the 6-3 as James Simmons digs in. Simmons with a single in the second inning. All he needs is a long fly ball. It could be an out, and it would be a sacrifice fly. Moss has a decent arm in left field. Cesar, almost every right fielder is a very good arm. The one-out toss, lifted foul to the right, 0-1. And Bubba Bell has a decent arm in center. There are some players in this league that do not have great arms in left. That's usually the case. The bat is where everyone distinguishes themselves, as the 0-1 is missed by Simmons. Nothing in two. Here to sink underneath the bat may have even been the changeup. The Skeeters appear to be willing to concede the run on a slow ground ball. They do not have their infielders in, even though it's the middle of the game. The 0-2, a jam shot, foul. Simmons swung the pitch about 3 inches off the inside corner. He usually stands about a foot to a foot and a half away from the inside corner because his arms are so long and he can reach that way. The 0-2 swung on and missed. Chase some high fastball. Simmons goes down, two away. Sends up Machete, Luis Rodriguez. A situation of late that the Bluefish have thrived. Runner at third base with two men out, which is why they've been scoring more runs. Luis Rodriguez over the last five games hitting .308. 0-1 today, pitch lofted in the air to center. Bubba Bell circles around towards left center and makes the catch for the final out of the frame. The Bluefish score a run on a solo drive from Prentice Redmond, but the Bluefish are still down by a run at the end of four. It's 2-1. Runner left on. Stay tuned. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
At Miller Lite, we believe if you're not choosing a light beer with more taste, you need to man up, not man down. Because up is way better than down. You don't tell someone sad to cheer down. What's down, dog? A steamy pile and you just stepped in it. Your girlfriend's not wearing a push-down bra. It's called gravity, Isaac Nitwit. Can I be down front with you? All this down talk is bringing me down. So don't man down, man up, and choose a light beer with more taste. Triple hops brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
This is Terry McGriff, pitching coach for the Bridgeport Bluefish, and you listen to Perry Miles on the Bluefish Broadcast.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms, the pace of the game, the mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together, just like a good team? At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community, too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community.
The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial, Inc.
Commemorative moments of the Little League World Series being shown. The regional set, which allowed them to go to that Little League World Series, and Fairfield did a great job in representing themselves as they are being introduced almost in every way, shown on the video board, introducing and reintroducing the Fairfield team that accomplished that much and was one of the final eight teams in the United States to make it. So kudos to them for their accomplishments as the Skeeters step up to the batter's box. It's Steve Moss, Josh Presley, Aaron Bates. 4, 5, and 6 in the order as Oseguera hopes to have an efficient fifth inning. It's not been that way so far for the Bluefish Southpaw. Two runs, eight base hits for Sugar Land, one run on four base hits for Bridgeport. Oseguera delivers, and the pitch spiked to the dirt, partially blocked as it heads to the screen. Nothing doing. I believe that was the ball with a strike indicated on the scoreboard. Find out in just a moment. Oseguera delivers again. Fastball low. Wait and find out what the story is. Matt Beaver indicating, I believe it's one ball, one strike. A left-handed Bluefish starter releases another fastball outside, 2-1. Bluefish after tonight, two games tomorrow, two sevens, followed by a nine-inning affair on Sunday. Bluefish have a day off. And for those of you out there tuning in, the 2-1, fastball high, three balls and one strike. At least that was one on the scoreboard. And Moss just jogs over to first base. It was a walk. Two walks on the day for Moss. Josh Presley digs in. We'd like to wish everyone a happy and healthy new year for all those who celebrate.
Number 31, Josh Presley.
I will be celebrating as well. Shana Tova. Josh Presley digs in, a walk. Rather a single and another one. RBI single left in the first and another single in the third. Leadoff walk tends to cause issues for any pitcher. If you look at Jeff Scott and the numbers that he crunched up, the next toss lands over the inside corner on 1-1. The batting average for when a pitcher gives up a leadoff walk is substantially worse. Opponent's batting average is much higher when there's a leadoff walk than when there isn't. It's all about the mental phase of the game. Throw to first, not in time. Even though it counts as the same number of bases, walk compared with hit. Same reasoning behind it. Same number of bases, but different results because you expend all that energy. The 0-1 from Oseguera. Fastball. Lined up low. One ball, one strike. We mentioned to you that it was a 2-0 game. Southern Maryland on top of Lancaster. It's still 2-0 in the top of the fifth. And the Barnstormers do not have much going on right now. Just one base hit, and that came from Everidge. Two hits from Jeremy Owens. He's doing his job. Nicholas and Padgett with RBI. Throw to first, not in time.
Welcome, Jaguar Markov.
Benjamin and Gutierrez have scored the runs for the road team. Southern Maryland was just here last night. They hit the Lancaster, and then Southern Maryland will be heading, I believe they're heading home. Quite a few games left in the schedule. 1-1. Sinks inside. Two balls and one strike. It is a three-game series against, I believe it's a three-game series against Lancaster, a three-game series against Camden, and a four-game series against Lancaster again. So more road games coming up for Southern Maryland. A long road trip towards the end of the year. 2-1. Lifted in the air down the right field line, but it is foul towards the Bluefish bullpen. Two balls and two strikes. A big swing, but Bates did not provide enough power, nor did he keep it in fair territory. Lefty-lefty situation. Presley in there. Open stance. Oseguera waits and fires. Pitches ground ball to short. Rogers flips to second. One. On to first. Double play. Two-way. Presley on the 6-4-3 DP. And with two out, here comes Bates. Single and an RBI and a fly ball to right.
Batting first baseman number 30, Aaron Bates.
Bates, a tremendous hitter a few years ago. and was in AAA baseball, signed a contract, Rochester, and also with Memphis. But there were plenty of departures which allowed Bates to come back to independent baseball. His services were no longer required. The next toss is outside, one ball and no strikes. Take a closer look at what Bates had done. Tremendous impact. The 1-0. Line drive looped into left field. It is a base hit as it rolls towards the corner. Fielded in the corner by Kennard Jones. He flicks it into the shortstop past Eddie Rogers into the second baseman Luis Figueroa. But it's a double for Bates. Runner in scoring position for Bubba Bell. So another line drive. This time taking care of business. Up the left field line.
Center fielder number 10, Bubba Bell.
Bell with 49 ribbies on the year. Batting towards the bottom of the order these days. Batting towards the top early in the season has moved around with Sugar Land trying to spread the offensive wealth. Two men out, a 2-1 game. The Bluefish need to keep this at a 2-1 margin. The two-out delivery blocked in the dirt on the forehand by Machete. One ball, no strikes. 8:40 on the East Coast. About an hour and a half into tonight's ball game. It's the top of the fifth. Sugar Land scored a run in the first and the third. Bluefish responded with a run in the fourth. The 1-0. Ground ball towards the middle. It gets through for a base hit. Rounding third and coming towards the plate is Bates. Simmons has to throw the ball into second base. Where Eddie Rogers is there. It's an RBI single for Bubba Bell, and the Bluefish now trail 3-1. Double play ground ball, then the double by Bates down the left field line. The Skeeters take advantage of extending the frame. RBI single, no errors in the game, but already 10 hits for the Sugar Land squad against Oseguera.
Second baseman number 23, Matt Hagen.
Matt Hagen moves in. Hagen will walk in a fly ball to right. Two men out, lefty versus righty. The next toss, foul tipped into the glove. 0-1. Everyone playing straight away. For the Bluefish in the outfield, Lopez hovering towards first. The 0-1 travels inside, one ball and one strike. Long inning for the Bluefish. Hagen had some affiliate experience, double A, and even some triple A experience. Open stance, setup is toward the inside corner, throw to first, not in time. Many of the players in this league have at least AAA experience, which is why the league has improved as substantially as it has. The 1-1. Another poke down the right field line, but this one drifts foul. A ball and two strikes. The Skeeters do what they're able to do, one part of batting very well, and similar to what Somerset does. Foul pitches off, stay alive, and find the right offering for them to tattoo or take advantage of. 1-2. Fastball outside and high. Two balls and two strikes. Oseguera approaching the 100 pitch mark on the day. He He may be a six-inning pitcher tonight. 2-2. Curveball. Filtered inside. Three balls and two strikes. A little bit of curve inside. About an hour north of New York City. Northeast. Three balls and two strikes. Oseguera deals a high chopper to the left side. It gets through for a base hit. Matt Hagen is on. Runners at first and second with Kennard Jones delivering the ball in. Octavio Martinez steps up. And you wonder when the Bluefish will start to get some arms loose in the pen. Kyle Zaleski pitched a couple of days ago when the Bluefish lost the middle game of the series. You had Juan El Mesa, and he was all over the place on Wednesday night. A two-out delivery, curveball in there, strike one. Every time Oseguera is getting ahead, but is unable to finish off the hitters. And part of that is because Sugar Land is fighting off the tough ones, finding the crease, finding out what Oseguera is trying to sneak through, and depositing the ball in the holes, whether it be on the left side of the infield, right side of the infield, or up the diamond, up the middle. No balls in one strike. Martinez, part of the York Revolution Championship squad last year, and Lancaster before that, as the pitch is lofted down the first baseline, but it swoops foul. It went over the leaping Luis Lopez as he scampered after it, but it tailed over his head and a couple of feet to the right of the chalk. 0-2. These two teams will probably not meet for the rest of the season. The Bluefish have a much better shot at making it to the playoffs, as indicated by the tragic number of Sugar Land. The 0-2. Fastball squeezes inside, one ball and two strikes. Left-hander awaits the 1-2. Fastball away, two balls and two strikes. Timeout is called. Louis Rodriguez quickly went to the mound. You cannot imagine what they're discussing about. The conversations are almost privileged between patient and client and attorney, or client and doctor. Rodriguez prescribing what the cure would be. Oseguera nodding his head saying this is what the symptoms are. 2-2. Line drive, one hop, flag down by Rogers. Throws to first in time, and that retires the side. The Bluefish, though, give up a run. They allow three base hits, and they leave.
All right, fans.
Two runners on. Bluefish are able to get out of the jam. It's 3-1 at the end of 4.5. Stay tuned. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms, the pace of the game, the mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together, just like a good team? At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community, too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community.
The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial, Inc.
Miller Time. Don't check your wrist or follow up with your supervisor, because Miller Time has nothing to do with when and everything to do with who.
What's up, Tommy?
Miller Lite is brewed for the guys you're proud to call your brothers, who'll always talk you out of getting that faux hawk and never talk
nice
during your backswing. And when you've got your brothers and the light beer that tastes like a beer should, yeah, it's not just a good time, it's Miller Time.
Great beer, great responsibility. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
Jimmy Rollins talks about the Baseball Hall of Fame.
Just being in the same place that all these great ball players, you know, reside at now, their career, you go find their stats, their jerseys, their helmets, their cleats, and have something of mine, that is something that anybody that goes to the Hall of Fame can see.
Preserving history, honoring excellence, connecting generations. At the National Baseball Hall of Fame and Museum in Cooperstown, New York. Connect with Cooperstown at baseballhall.org.
An increase in the lead for the Bluefish to have to handle. It's 3-1 Sugar Land on top. Jason Lane on the hill. As the left-hander must deal with Luis Figueroa, Brad Boyer, and Denard Jones. So far, a solo shot allowed by Lane. And after a double by Otañez, he seemed to settle down. And the Bluefish, looking at O'Segara for the sixth inning, the fastball stays elevated. One ball and no strikes. .311 for the Fish. The fastball is a frisbee to the outside corner. One ball, one strike. This is what Jason Lane has done much of the year. It's very solid, not a strong fastball. The next toss is upstairs. Two balls and one strike. But he's able to vary his off-speed pitches and keep the Bluefish hitters off balance. 2-1. Pop up behind the plate. Martinez throws away his mask. He's towards the netting. And did he make the catch? He did not. The ball dropped out of his glove towards the padded wall. Two balls and two strikes. He was pinned against the netting and he had to be very careful, because he wanted to make sure he protected the baseball and could not. Diagonal closer to the Bluefish on deck circle rather than the Skeeters imaginary circle. Two balls and two strikes. Lane waits, delivers, pitch, line drive, base hit, center field. Figueroa is on. Start off the fifth inning. So he's 1-for-2. Brad Boyer steps up. Bluefish have not been able to string too many hits together. They had the solo drive and the Tawny's hit. It's the first time in the game, last inning, that the Bluefish had strung consecutive hits together. The key to taking care of Nick Green and Dan Reichert in the last series was doing just that. Reichert, it was hit after hit after hit after hit. Eventually, a sacrifice fly worked into the equation. The first pitch is on the inside corner, 0-1. Brad Boyer already 1-for-1 and sends a high fly ball to deep right field. On the move is Cesar, and he's able to make the catch as he stretched his right arm out with the glove. One away. A nice play by the corner outfielder. It's an F9 as Boyer goes back and Kennard Jones faces up against Lane. The Bluefish have been putting better contact, much more authoritative contact against Lane second time around. It may even be better third time around. There is no activity in the Skeeters bullpen and there's nothing going on in the Bluefish world down the right field line. The one out toss on the inside corner, 0-1. Jones is 0-for-2. Fly ball to center. And a foul out to the catcher. Southpaw stares at first. Figueroa has stolen a few bases, throw to first not in time, but he's been hampered a bit. Just like many of the Bluefish players. stole a few bases with Sugar Land, but has been caught twice with the Bluefish. Next pitch, ground ball, base hit right field. Figueroa takes a turn around second, but stops there as Cesar sends it over to the shortstop Ramos in the relay to third base. Runners at first and second for Eddie Rogers. Starting to see Jason Lane unravel, not throwing the same kind of strikes second time or even third time around now with Jones that he was the first time around. And that's what distinguishes between the elite pitchers in this league and those that are not as fantastic. O'Segara has been consistent, giving up hits and the opposition scoring one run every other inning. It seems like the Morse code. One out, delivery, line drive, base hit, center field. Luis Figueroa rounding third. He stops as he had to fall to the ground to stop himself. Willie Upshaw told him to go around, but Figueroa was intelligent. He would have been gunned at the plate. It was a great throw by Bubba Bell to Octavio Martinez with one man out. Figueroa put on the big brakes. Britt Burns on his way to the hill, the pitching coach for the Skeeters, one of the assistants for Gaetti, just like Terry McGriff is the bench coach and the official, well, the unofficial pitching coach, but he is the bench coach. He's second in line to Willie Upshaw. Seventh base hit of the game, and the Bluefish loaded the bases on singles. We'll see if Prentice Redmond is able to take care of business. The tying run probably would score on a single. With two out, a single would definitely score Kennard Jones from second base as long as it went to the outfield. The runners would be moving on contact. Right now, the only time that the Bluefish players would be moving on contact is if the ball hit the ground immediately. One Bridgeport batter out. Prentice Redmond with a home run in this game. The one-out pitch. Swung on and driven to deep left field. Moss moving back. He's at the track. He's at the wall. That ball's gone. Three-run shot, Prentice Redmond. Grand slam, Prentice Redmond. The Bluefish are leading now by a score of 5-3. Two home runs for Redmond. Ripped it again to the same spot. Moss had no chance. Grand slam for Prentice Redmond. His second home run of the night. And he now has five ribbies, and he has propelled the Bluefish to the lead as Willis Otanez digs in. Lane delivers. High pop to the right side of the outfield. The second baseman, Hagen, moving back, and then Cesar moves forward to make the catch. Two-way. That ball was crushed by Redmond. Otanez, F9. Luis Lopez stands in.
First baseline,
update
19,
time on BridgeportBluefish.com. Southern Maryland leads Lancaster 2-0 in the top half of the sixth inning with a runner at first. Brockman versus Gabby Hernandez. Two-out pitch, fastball. Scales low, one ball and no strikes. A grand slam home run from Prentice Redmond. And he would not let this team be behind in this game. They have surged back against Lane. The 1-0 leans to the inside corner. One ball and one strike. The 1-1. A high pop to the right side of the infield. Aaron Bates backpedals. He's called off by Matt Hagen, who makes the play. The second baseman retires the final batter of the frame, but the Bluefish score four times. A grand slam by Prentice Redmond, his second homer of the night. The Bluefish lead 5-3 at the end of five. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Come and join the Bluefish for a playoff push in 2012. The Bluefish have great options from picnics and birthday parties to harbor club outings and sweet leases. Invite your friends, family, or co-workers out to the ballpark for an exciting night of affordable family fun. Kids celebrating a birthday party at the ballpark will get an autographed baseball, a visit from BB the Bluefish, and much, much more, including a chance to compete in the best on-field promotions Connecticut has to offer. Don't miss out on the final home games of the regular season. Book your outing with the Bluefish today. Call 203-345-4800 to schedule an unforgettable day at the ballpark in Harbor Yard during the 15th anniversary season. Or go to BridgeportBluefish.com. Bridgeport Bluefish Baseball. Get hooked.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms, the pace of the game, the mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together, just like a good team? At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community, too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community.
The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates.
Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial, Inc.
What a turn of events as the Bluefish score four runs in the fifth inning on a grand slam by Prentice Redmond to change the tide over. The momentum carried from Sugar Land, where they scored a run the fifth inning, all the way back to the Bluefish. Oseguera is on the hill for a sixth inning of work. There is some activity brewing down the right field line for the Bluefish, and it appears to be Patrick Bresnahan who might start to warm up for the Bridgeport squad. Jesse English is certainly available tonight. Julio DePaula, Rami Lewis. Those three are available, and Bresnahan is the one that's standing up down the right field line as the pitch is lofted foul to the right, nothing and one. But Bresnahan quickly, well, no, he pulled an audible. He was about to sit down, and then he, grabbed his glove and is staying there. Pitches pounded into the ground, foul to the left, nothing and two. Today, Dominic Ramos, 0-for-3. The one who follows him in the order of Filio Castro has caused all kinds of problems for the Bluefish left-hander. 3 hits and 3 ABs for Castro. Two players have had similar averages over this time. 11 for 32, 10 for 33 over the last two series. Fastball shoveled up by Machete. 1-2. Great night at the ballpark at Harbor Yard. And the fans enjoying it because of the resiliency of the way that the Bluefish were able to overcome that deficit. The way that Lane had been successful for all that time. The 1-2 flattens outside, 2-2. It shows the fortitude that this team has during the latter stages of the season. One who might have followed the Bluefish throughout might have said they could have done this throughout the year. 2-2, foul tipped at the plate. Count remains 2-2. The only thing that matters is their competitive fire right now. Southern Maryland's and Bridgeport right now playing some of the best baseball in the Atlantic League. And those two teams are duking it out for the division title and hoping, the Bluefish are, that Lancaster is able to take care of Southern Maryland. Southern Maryland hoping Bridgeport stumbles. 2-2. High pop down the right field line, foul into the low seating. two balls and two strikes. The only two runs scoring on RBI from Nicholas and Paget. And that's not one name, it's two names. Cesar Nicholas had some key base hits in the last series. The 2-2, fastball on the edge, strike three. Ramos goes down. As Oseguera, hoping to have a quality start in this game. Five and a third innings. His third strikeout, and Oseguera at 110 plus pitches. That is a ton for the lefty, coming a day after a season high for the Bluefish in pitches thrown by Mike Ness. One out delivery, line drive to center field. It is a base hit as it is served in front of James Simmons. He throws the ball to Eddie Rogers. The tying run comes to the plate, represented by Dionis Cesar. The 12th hit of the night allowed by Oseguera, and 15 base runners have reached in five and a third. Somehow, the Bluefish left-hander has been able to avoid the big inning and has been able to strand Skeeter's base runners. Most of the hits have been singles, and they've been scattered between outs. Some of the hits have resulted in rundowns because of uncharacteristic blunders on the base pack. Dionis Cesar, a victim of that earlier. The one out flip is on the outside corner, 0-1.
Grab yourself a freshly baked cookie for just a buck. And the new Bluefish general manager, Ken Shepard.
3-12-0 to 5-8-0. The wind is beginning to pick up. It's out towards left field these times. May help the right-handed batters a little bit more. Left-handers have not been helped much this series at all. Have not been helped in general. You have to smack the ball. The 0-1 is inside, one ball and one strike. You had Benjamin and Daniel hit home runs for the Blue Crabs, but those pitches were centered. It was almost as if those two were hitting batting practice fastballs. I'm sure most people could hit a fastball right down the middle. 1-1, inside, the runner goes. The throw to second is in plenty of time. He's gunned. Caught stealing, 2-4. Castro tried against Machete. It seems as if Rodriguez's cannon reappeared in his accuracy right there. Two balls and one strike with two men out. Oseguera lifts the leg and deals. Pitch is chopped on the ground to the shortstop, Rogers. He flips to first in time. And the Bluefish put up a zero after they score four runs in the fifth inning. It's a 5-3 Bluefish lead against the Skeeters. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Behind everything you're searching for is something you're actually looking for. When you flip through the real yellow pages for a plumber, you're actually looking to reclaim your home from a renegade faucet. It's not just getting directions to a tailor with YP.com. It's looking your best for an interview. And it's more than finding a mechanic with YP.com on your mobile. It's getting your road trip back on track. Whatever it might be, there are more ways to search and more ways to find exactly what you're looking for with the real yellow pages, YP.com, and YP.com on your mobile, only from AT&T. Behind everything you're searching for is something you're actually looking for. When you search with the real yellow pages, you get more than a contractor. You get a whole new curb appeal. It's not just getting directions to a dry cleaner with YP.com. It's rescuing an old favorite from the back of the closet. And it's more than finding a locksmith with YP.com on your mobile. It's getting to sleep in your own bed. Whatever it might be, there are more ways to search and more ways to find exactly what you're looking for with the real yellow pages, YP.com, and YP.com on your mobile, only from AT&T.
A sizzling, succulent filet mignon, scrumptious salmon Florentine, savory twin grilled pork chops. Getting hungry? Your table awaits at the Park City Grill, Fairfield County's elegant new dining spot in the beautifully renovated Bridgeport Holiday Inn. Comfortable, warm, and inviting, Park City Grill offers a world-class dining experience at reasonable prices. Come to the Park City Grill, 1070 Main Street in the Bridgeport Holiday Inn. Take I-95 exit 27A to exit 2. Plenty of free, secure parking.
Bridgeport Bluefish Baseball back for the bottom of the sixth inning. The trivia question for today: which member of the Bluefish had the most hits against the Skeeters this season? Which member of the Bluefish had the most hits against the Skeeters this season? And we will update you on that trivia question coming up in the seventh. The answer is coming in the seventh inning. Bluefish able to escape further trouble. Caught stealing, assisted in that batter. James Simmons steps up. Extended his on-base streak to 12 in a row. The first pitch delivered on the outside corner, 0-1. 3-12-0 to 5-8-0. The pitch is served foul. Off the netting. No balls and two strikes. It's been a great day, especially for Prentice Redmond, as the fastball turns upstairs, one ball and two strikes. He can certainly drive in runs, but he's had an exceptional night catching the baseball too. The next toss is fought off to the right. One ball, two strikes. Redmond had six RBI on the first of this month. If he gets one more home run, he will have had a season high, and that is the pitch is grounded to third. The throw to first could not be scooped up at first by Bates. It was going to be a difficult play because of Simmons' speed, and that is ruled as a base hit. 2-for-3 on the day for Simmons. There is nobody faster on the Bluefish than Simmons, which is why he's covering center field rather than Joey Gathright. Even though Gathright gets plenty of reps in center and was the starting center fielder to begin the year. Simmons has those thoroughbred horse-type legs, the way that he's able to march and the way that he glides. He's going 25, 30 miles an hour on the sprint. He is fleet of foot. Throw to first, not in time. 12 stolen bases. And just one time that he's been caught this year. Grand slam home run. And a solo shot by Prentice Redmond, accounting for the Bluefish scoring in the last two frames. This is the sixth line drive base hit left field. Luis Rodriguez. Back-to-back singles for the Fish. Luis Figueroa steps up, and you wonder if Figueroa is going to bunt. It is the sixth inning. Runners at first and second. The bunt pushes the runner up 90 feet to possibly get an insurance run with a long fly ball. Will Willie Upshaw implement that strategy? Luis Figueroa certainly looks like it is. His body turned forward for a moment before he gets into his regular stance. The Sugar Land corner infielders expecting bunt. Bates is at the lip, so is Castro. No bunt shown. Fastball stays high. One ball and no strikes. The middle infielders, Ramos and Hagen, playing halfway, anticipating the double play ball. Figueroa has some speed over there. The 1-0 fought off foul to the right. One ball and one strike. Not every time is a Bluefish player going to try to lay down the bunt. The Bluefish may feel they have lain on the ropes ready for the knockout punch. And Figueroa's an intelligent ball player. He understands. As the pitch is lifted in the air, it is a base hit as it dunks forward into right field. A big turn, and Simmons goes through the stop sign. The throw is not in time. Great slide by James Simmons. He ran right through the stop sign by Willie Upshaw, and the shoulder first slide tapped the plate. Octavio Martinez, surprise. It was a late swipe. Gary Gaetti comes to object to the call, but there is nothing that can change the mind of the home plate umpire, Matt Beaver. The explanation given by Beaver to Gaetti, he is angered. That was a bloop base hit by Figueroa, but give all the credit to James Simmons for his hustle around the bases to score the run. And Luis Rodriguez winds up at third base on the throw home. Runners at the corners, it's a 6-3 game. Have not seen this kind of play from the Bluefish in a long time. A hungry, hustling ball club. The way that they have displayed themselves. The first pitch is outside, one ball and no strikes. It is a beautiful thing to watch. And Simmons is the fastest guy, and you saw why. A shallow blue fly ball. Simmons did not get a great jump off of second and still scored. The 1-0 is on the outside corner. One ball and one strike. The center fielder, Bubba Bell, angle towards left center. Cesar. Midway, the 1-1. A chopper to the right side. Chop step forward for Hagen. Flips to second, one. No throw to first. It's an RBI for Brad Boyer. The Bluefish extend the lead at 7-3. Theater's choice, 4-6. So Boyer picks up an RBI, and the Bluefish have scored 7 runs in the last 3 offensive frames. Jason Lane remains in the game, but there is bullpen activity down the left field line for the Skeeters. Not too many lefties in the bullpen. Appears to be Will Startup as the pitch is launched into right field. Angling over to make the catch is Dionis Cesar, and the throw to second base. It went there, but it was dropped. It was trapped, and Boyer was confused. So, Kennard Jones is safe first on a fielder's choice. 9-6. Looked like Cesar was coming in to make the catch, and then the throw came into Ramos, who alertly applied the tag. Two men out, fielder's choice. Don't see that too often with a player as fast as Boyer on the base paths. Two out delivery, a cue ball shot sent foul. 0-1. Seven 11-0 to 3-12-0. The other lefties in the bullpen, Kelvin Villa, Scott Kazmir. Kazmir's a starter going tomorrow, so he's not coming in. And there's a chance Kelvin Villa could also go to the hill tomorrow. Fastball outside, one ball, one strike. So it is Will Startup. 6 feet, 195 pounds out of Nashville, Tennessee. The last team was with the Norfolk Tides, the Baltimore Orioles affiliate for the last 5 years or so. The 1-1 lands on the outside corner at the knees, ball and two strikes. Rogers with a single and a run scored. A double could plate Jones and extend his RBI streak. A triple would definitely do that, at a home run for sure. Slide step. The runner goes. The pitch is grounded to the right side. It hits the bat, the runner, and the runner is out. It hit Eddie Rogers as he was crossing to the second base bag. Hagen was angling towards second base on the hit and run, and he would have had to have fallen down just to block the ball. But the Skeeters get a break, not before the Bluefish strike for two more runs on three base hits. One runner left on. At the end of six, the Bluefish lead 7-3. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on Bridgeport Bluefish.com.
A sizzling, succulent filet mignon, scrumptious 714, savory twin grilled pork chops. Getting hungry? Your table awaits at the Park City Grill, Fairfield County's elegant new dining spot in the beautifully renovated Bridgeport Holiday Inn. Comfortable, warm, and inviting. Park City Grill offers a world-class dining experience at reasonable prices. Come to the Park City Grill, 1070 Main Street, and the Bridgeport Holiday Inn. Take I-95 exit 27A to exit 2. Plenty of free, secure parking.
Baseball legend Henry Aaron reflects on his Hall of Fame legacy.
I think that since I played for the public, they need to share what I did in my life as for baseball. It's the proudest moment of my life to give everything to the Hall of Fame. I often tell people they need to get and see it. There is no other building in the world like the Hall of Fame in baseball.
Celebrate the game. Celebrate the legacy. Connect with Cooperstown at baseballhall.org.
Hey kids, it's not too late to join BB and all of his friends by becoming a member of the Bluefish Snappers Club. The Snappers Club is the newest club for all of the biggest or littlest Bluefish fans. As a member of the Snappers Club, you'll not only get free entrance on Snappers Club Day, but you'll also get a membership card to show all of your friends, plus a special t-shirt that will tell everyone you're a member of the club. After each Sunday home game, Baseball Bunch members will also be invited onto the field to run the bases, just like the Bluefish do. You'll even receive a newsletter that will fill you in on all of your favorite Bluefish players, along with all the news that BB Snappers Club has to offer. To join the coolest club around, call 203-345-4800 or go to bridgeportbluefish.com/kids/snappers to become a member of BB's Snappers Club.
Bridgeport Bluefish Baseball is here for the seventh inning, top of the seventh. This call to the bullpen is presented by Prudential Annuities. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for our community. Jesse English. When it's sad but true, it's Rami Lewis. When it's wherever I may roam, it's Jesse English on the hill. Both songs courtesy of Metallica. Osiera's final line, six innings. Three earned runs, 12 hits, three walks, three strikeouts, 115 pitches for the southpaw, 67 of them in the strike zone. He can win the game. He cannot lose it. English is ready. The first pitch. Fastball to the inside corner, 0-1. English at 1.16 and a third innings of one-run baseball this year. And in the month of August and September, leveled off a bit before going well again. The next pitch is a fastball outside, one ball and one strike. English, three wins and no losses in ERA, 3.14, 51 and two-thirds innings this season for English. Southpaw features a fastball and a breaking pitch as the next toss swerves inside, two balls and one strike. A cup of coffee in the big leagues for English as he spent time with the Washington Nationals back in 2010. Third baseman Brad Boyer, way back towards the lip of the outfield grass, the 2-1. A high drive, right field line, out of play. Two balls and two strikes. Two home runs for Prentice Redmond. An RBI single by Luis Figueroa. An RBI fielder's choice by Brad Boyer. That accounts for all the runs tonight for the Bluefish. For the Skeeters, a different story. We'll tell that after the 2-2 lifted foul to the right. Josh Presley, an RBI single. Aaron Bates, an RBI single. Bubba Bell, a ribby base hit. But Oseguera got through six. registers another quality start. Two balls and two strikes. Next one flattened outside. English awaits. Glove at the belt, lifts the leg, 2-2. Slicer foul. Line drive, almost caught by one of the fans. I believe it may have even been caught by one of the fans of the glove. Whatever you do, if you go to a ballpark, you go to any event, make sure you watch the game, and specifically the baseball game, bring your glove, protect yourself, watch the game. You have a flying baseball, flying bat, or a broken bat. 2-2. Fastball leans inside, three balls and two strikes. Long pitch counts. For many of these Bluefish pitchers, Sugar Land has caused that to happen. Three balls and two strikes, glove at the belt, ball secured, 3-2. Another foul ball. Moss was known for that, being a mosquito, if you will, or a gnat for everyone, except for the team that he participated with. The Bluefish loved him. Patient approach, consistent hitting. That's why the Skeeters wanted his services. Skeeters landed him for proximity reasons. Walking a single for Moss today. 3-2. Check swing did go around. Strike three, the throw to first around the horn, and Moss is perturbed by the call. He picks up his bat. He thought it was a low pitch, and he did not go through the zone, but Matt Beaver indicates that's not the case. A strikeout for English. One away. English strikes out quite a few batters.
Hitter, number 31, Josh Presley.
Josh Presley with a walk and a single today. 12 base hits by each team. Different productivity scales for each side. Bluefish just have earned more extra base hits and more run scoring plays. Strum together better. The first offering is launched down the left field line, but Kennard Jones runs out of room. It falls into the picnic area. No balls and one strike. Tickets for the rest of the weekend series available. You can call a ticket sales representative at 203-345-4800. And ask for extension 119 or 151. Great day tomorrow. 14 innings of baseball. The 0-1 inside, one ball, one strike. Two for the price of one. Low seats, reserved seats, field box. Of course, the Harbor Club. And the luxury suites and party suites on the top level. One ball and one strike. Lefty-lefty scenario as Presley takes a big rip and fouls it to the netting. A ball and two strikes. Will Startup appears to be ready down the left field line. That's the one who is warming up. Never know, Sugar Land may have gotten a right-hander up. Right after he sat down, the 1-2 settles low into the dirt. Two balls and two strikes. We want to thank everybody for tuning in tonight on RichportBluefish.com. Perry Miles with you. It is a 7-3 contest. 2-2. Foul tipped. Did it stay in the glove? Yes, it did. Strike three. I don't know how Luis Rodriguez held on to that baseball, but somehow got mid on it. Two strikeouts in the inning for English. Entering today, he's averaging about that much. About a strikeout an inning. 52 strikeouts and 51 and two-thirds innings. That average will increase.
How about in first base number 30, Aaron Bates?
Aaron Bates brings the piece of the lumber up to the plate. 2-3 for Bates. Notice how the middle of the order, Moss reached twice. Presley had two hits. Bates had two hits. Skeeters have just three runs. One out toss, or rather two out tosses outside. One ball and no strikes. The Dominic Ramos has been left off. He has no hits, and Octavio Martinez does not have a hit tonight. 1-0. Fastball to the edge. One ball, one strike.
Come on, Bluefish fan. I want to hear you. Come on, let's go.
It was all Sugar Land early. Jason Lane got through the first few innings without any trouble. 1-1. Swung on and missed a ball and two strikes. But it's about the second and third time around in the order. And Lane got touched up a bit. All those runs are earned. It's the end of his night. Bluefish have a four-run margin. Comfortable lead right now. The 1-2. Swung on and missed. Blistering fastball to the outside corner and got him. English strikes out the side with a little bit of English on the ball. And the Bluefish shift to the bottom of the seventh, 7-3 to score. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
At Miller Lite, we know there's only one thing baseball fans love as much as great Pilsner taste, and that's rooting for the home team. Because home is way better than away. Away is not where the heart is. Bringing away the bacon? Why? Bacon is delicious. Away is where you hang your hat? You should be hung up by your underpanties. So why root for the away team when you can root for the home team with a great Pilsner taste of Miller Lite? Triple hops brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Come and join the Bluefish for a playoff push in 2012. The Bluefish have great options from picnics and birthday parties to harbor club outings and sweet leases. Invite your friends, family, or coworkers out to the ballpark for an exciting night of affordable family fun. Kids celebrating a birthday party at the ballpark will get an autographed baseball, a visit from BB the Bluefish, and much, much more, including a chance to compete in the best on-field promotions Connecticut has to offer. Don't miss out on the final home games of the regular season. Book your outing with the Bluefish today. Call 203-345-4800 to schedule an unforgettable day at the ballpark in Harbor Yard during the 15th anniversary season, or go to BridgeportBluefish.com. Bridgeport Bluefish Baseball. Get hooked.
This has been a great event to watch for Bluefish fans. This call to the bullpen is presented by Prudential Annuities. Prudential Annuities going to bat for our community. Will Startup is on the hill. The southpaw of the Norfolk Tides. That was his last team before he joined the Skeeters out of Nashville, Tennessee. Startup on the year. 3 wins and 2 losses in 29 games. A 3 ERA for the left-handed reliever. 39 innings, opponents hitting 240 against him, and he will have to deal with Prentice Redman, followed by Willis Otanias and Luis Lopez. For those of you out there who may be confused about the ruling of the final out, Eddie Rogers delivered a ball towards the middle on a hit and run. And the Bluefish base runner was hit by the baseball going by. If it hits the base runner, the defensive player that's closest to the baseball is attributed with the out. And the runner eliminated. First pitch, fastball, low, one ball, no strikes. It counts as a hit for Eddie Rogers, but the runner is out on a 4-run assisted. Interesting play, and rarely see it happen. Anyway, the 1-0, fastball low, two balls, no strikes. This is the first time that we've seen a base runner hit with the baseball this year. Either at the ballpark at Harbor Yard or on the road with Bluefish. I'm sure it may have happened once or twice across the league. The 2-0 from Startup. Fastball sent inside. Three balls, no strikes. The final line for Lane. 6 innings, 7 runs, 12 hits, 4 strikeouts, 91 strikes, or rather 91 pitches, 67 of them in the zone. 3-0, fastball, pinned low, ball 4. Redmond walks. He's reached base for the third time today. So many productive days for the Bluefish offensively, which has allowed them to excel. Southern Maryland with a 3-0 lead in the top of the seventh inning, and Southern Maryland is threatening. The bases are loaded with one man out, Chingun Lo on the hill for the Barnstormer. First pitch, high chopper towards short, gobbled up, throw to second one, on to first, spike throw, nice play on one knee by Aaron Bates to retire two. It's a double play. Ramos, Hagen, Bates, 6-4-3. So Tanez is 1-for-4. Luis Lopez steps up to the dish. Gabby Hernandez with 6 scoreless innings in Lancaster. Everyone knows how difficult it is to pitch a clipper because of the short right field porch. Not nearly the same kind of dimensions at this venue. A bright field, ballpark at Harbor Yard. 2 out pitch, fastball. Lands low, 1 ball and no strikes. And now it's 4-0 Southern Maryland. The 1-0. Splits to the outside corner, 1 ball, 1 strike. It was a bases-loaded walk by Matt Padgett that scored the run. He's driven in 2 today. The 1-1, a grounder to short. 3 hops, handled by Ramos. He delivers to first. It's in time for the final out of the frame. Oh, the Bluefish players were retired in order. The double play eliminated the base runner on the walk. The Bluefish lead 7-3 at the end of 7. Stay tuned. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Hey kids, it's not too late to join BB and all of his friends by becoming a member of the Bluefish Snappers Club. The Snappers Club is the newest club for all the biggest or littlest Bluefish fans. As a member of the Snappers Club, you'll not only get free entrance on Snappers Club Day, but you'll also get a membership card to show all of your friends, plus a special t-shirt that will tell everyone you're a member of the club. After each Sunday home game, Baseball Bunch members will also be invited onto the field to run the bases, just like the Bluefish do. You'll even receive a newsletter that will fill you in on all of your favorite Bluefish players, along with all the news that BB Snappers Club has to offer. To join the coolest club around, call 203-345-4800 or go to BridgeportBluefish.com/kids/snappers to become a member of BB's Snappers Club.
Hey Bluefish fans, have you heard about the clubhouse? Conveniently located in Fairfield, it has an unparalleled team of baseball and softball instructors offering private instruction, camps, team training rentals, and best of all, the chance to learn from an all-pro team including Mike Porzio, former MLB pitcher, and the Bluefish's very own Willie Upshaw. Open 7 days a week, stop in and meet our team, or call us 203-292-8700 and visit us at the web, theclubhouseCT.com, and get the Major League experience.
This is another inning for Jesse English. Last time he worked 2 frames. Now it's 2 scoreless innings the last time. It took place 9-11, which was 3 days ago. The Bluefish won that game 11-4. So English, the most number of innings that he has pitched this season is 3 innings. He has not earned a save this season, but with the Bluefish up by 4, it's not a save situation right now unless English gives up a run. The Bluefish are unable to score in the bottom of the 8th. 3 runs or less, or if the on-deck batter represents the tying run. That's when it's a save situation. The fastball is inside, 1 ball and no strikes. The bases could be loaded. The team is up by four. That would be a safe situation. Team is up by five. Bases loaded. That would be a safe situation. Six or more, definitely not a save, and usually it's three with nobody on. The pitch is stroke foul to the left. That's the rule. One ball, one strike. Best closer in the history of baseball. Well, of course, Mariano Rivera. Some would say Trevor Hoffman. And yesterday there was a conversation between RJ Garcia and yours truly, which featured about left-handed closers. You don't see too many of those because the Bluefish have Rami Lewis. Billy Wagner is probably the best left-handed closer in the history of the sport. 1-1, swung on and missed. A ball and two strikes. Of course, you could say Dennis Eckersley for righties or Lee Smith. Those two were dominant. Sparky Lyle, the Somerset manager, could be considered among the best. 1-2. Fastball cruises outside. Two balls and two strikes. But it is such a difficult art to perfect. Closing. Business and law and baseball, it is tough. 2-2 is lifted in the air down the right field line. It is a base hit as it rolls towards the corner. Recovered in the corner by Prentice Redmond. He fires it in. It is a leadoff double for Bubba Bell. He is 3-for-4 tonight. That's the 13th hit for the Skeeters. A four-hit night from Castro, two-hit nights from Presley, Bates, and Bell, and they're still not winning the game, and they're still four runs down. The Bluefish have been the reason why that's the case. They have four multiple-hit nights from their batters, Rogers, Redmond, Simmons, and Figueroa, as Rodriguez has a conversation, a brief one, with English.
The batting second baseman, number 23, Matt Hagen.
Matt Hagen steps up. Lefty versus righty. Hagen, a single and a walk. First pitch, fastball. Pinned low. One ball and no strikes. No bullpen activity yet for the Bluefish. You can easily see someone getting loose if English gives up a run. The 1-0. Off the end of the bat. One ball, one strike. Matt Hagen. The story goes on and on about him. He came to Texas because he's from the state, close to it. Wanted to be closer to home. And in Texas, 2-hour drive really isn't too far. 1-1, high fly ball to deep left field. Kenar Jones racing back. He's near the track and makes the play, tagging and moving to third, Bubba Bell, as the throw comes into shortstop, Eddie Rogers. With one man out, one fan screaming for an appeal.
Catcher number 16.
I doubt that the Bluefish are going to challenge that. Bell scampers over to third base on an F7 more towards the left center field alley. Octavio Martinez moves in. Quickly action with what appears to be maybe Patrick Bresnahan down the right field line. The release outside on a heater. One of them is Bresnahan, and the other one appears to be the Paula. The one that's closest to the line is Bresnahan. He's getting his warm-up tosses to Terry McGriff as the fastball tucked inside. Two balls, no strikes. DePaula appears to be ready. DePaula's situation, eighth inning. But he can close. We've seen him do it with the Bluefish this year. 2-0. Sky foul to the right, 2-1. One of the few times that Martinez has been ahead in the count. Two balls, no strikes, two balls, one strike. Three balls, one strike, considered ahead in the count. Behind 0-2, 1-2. Not 0-1. Usually determined by the third pitch. Hurdlers want early contact or being getting the hitter behind the count. 2-1 is stroke foul of the netting. 2-2. Ramos is waiting in the on-deck circle. A Skeeters loss would mean the tragic number for them is 2. And the Bluefish are hoping that Lancaster can make some sort of run in that game. Runner on first base for Lancaster, 4-0, 2-2. Drive towards right center field. It is a base hit as it floats in. Simmons spins around and fires to the second baseman, Luis Figueroa. It's an RBI single for Octavio Martinez. Bluefish now lead by a score of 7-4. Nice piece of hitting for Martinez. Let the ball lay on the outside corner and handled it to the opposite field. True pro.
Shortstop number 4, Dominic Ramos.
Couple of pop flies by the shortstop to second. Strikeout as well on the day, he's 0-4. Leading off of first base, Martinez takes outside, 1-1, no strikes. He's not a threat to go. He's one of the few players on the Skeeters that are not threats to go. They're not great stolen base guys, but they're players that when they need to, they do take the initiative, go the extra 90 feet. 1-0 is spurred foul to the right, 1-1, one strike. Fourteen hits for the Skeeters, 4 runs, 12 hits for the Bluefish, 7 runs. No errors tonight. Game time, 7:13. Past the 2.5 hour mark from the ballpark at Harbor Yard in the top of the 8th. 1-1, dip to the outside corner for a strike. 1-1 and 2 strikes. This point in the season, every pitcher knows every batter, unless they're so new, so many times around, word gets around. 1-2 is spiked into the left center field. Pretty well hit. James Simmons moving back. He won't get there. He has to play it off the wall. Stopping at third base, Octavio Martinez, as Ramos sets his eyes for second. It is a double off of English. Runners at second and third with the tying run coming to the plate, and Castro is 4-for-4. Bresnahan continues to warm up. We'll see how much longer English stays in the game. Willie Upshaw emerges from the dugout, points the bill of his cap, and he's looking down the right field line, but he has not made any indication. Now he does. And we believe that Julio DePaula might be the one called on to come into the game. This call to the bullpen is presented by Prudential Annuities. Prudential Annuities going to bat for our community. One man out, runners at second and third. It's a 7-4 game in the top of the 8th inning. DePaula in when we return on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Of baseball. Is it the uniforms? The pace of the game? The mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together, just like a good team? At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community
by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community, too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community.
The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial, Inc.
Julio DePaula is on the mound for the Bluefish. This call to the bullpen is presented by Prudential Annuities. Prudential Annuities going to bat for our community. English goes in a third. He struck out the side in the seventh, but Sugar Land, the Skeeters, they've taken a couple bites out of him. One run given up by English, three base hits, and the runner at second and third, his responsibility. DePaula this year has been especially solid with the Bluefish after coming over from the Mexican League. DePaula, 3.09 ERA, one win and two losses in 30 games. Two saves, 35 innings. Opponents hitting 256 against him, and he struck out more than a batter per inning as he must deal with Ofidio Castro. Castro is 4-for-4 tonight. Bluefish in danger of giving up another run. DePaula wants to prevent that result. One man out, top of the eighth. DePaula lifts the leg, the toss chopped into the ground, foul to the left. This is easily the most difficult matchup that Castro's had all night. Not that Oseguera is a poor pitcher, he's a very good pitcher. But it's a righty versus a righty with a devastating slider, as opposed to Oseguera and English, who are both lefties. A little bit easier to see compared with the righty as the body twitch, the next toss, slider away, one ball, one strike. Early on the season, DePaula gave up quite a few home runs. Those numbers have settled down. It's because the slider has worked for him effectively. 1-1. Downward break, two balls and one strike. Appeared to be that breaking ball. He has got the fastball, the slider, and the break. The slider looks like a whip. Jutting outside from over the top, the area in which the baseball covers. 2-1 to Castro. Swung on and missed. It appeared as if Castro was fading away from the plate on the breaking ball, expecting fastball, trying to chop his swing down a little bit so that way he could generate power off the back leg. Two balls and two strikes. One man out. DePaula releases a chopper to the first baseman, Lopez. He looks at home but decides to step on first base. It is an RBI for Castro. Three unassisted. The Bluefish are now ahead by a score of 7-5. As Castro is retired for the first time tonight. Three unassisted. Dionis Cesar has a chance to tie the game with one swing. And the Bluefish want to guarantee that does not take place. Batting from the left side against the right-handed DePaula. Two men out. Cesar, switch hitter batting. The next pitch on the inside corner, 0-1. That appeared to be that slider breaking inside. Many left-handed batters have that sweet spot low and in. Drop the bat head, ball dry, carries very far. DePaula tested that theory. Cesar did not pull the trigger. Next toss floats low. One ball and one strike. Five runs, 15 base hits. Seven runs, 12 hits. Bluefish lead by a couple. Cesar backs out. 1-for-4 on the day, a single in the first, a fly ball to center fielder James Simmons. Back-to-back at bats in the third and the fourth, 6-3 ground balls. He takes a big whiff. Cut out and missed. One ball and two strikes. Center fielder James Simmons, angled just to the left of where the 405 would be. Now he drifts towards the 405. The 1-2 just skates outside. Two balls and two strikes. Bailed off the corner at the last moment. We want to thank everybody for tuning in on BridgeportBluefish.com tonight. We'll get the scoreboard update to you in the bottom of the eighth for the major leagues. And one more update from Lancaster. The 2-2 is low. Rodriguez blocked it. 3-2. Cesar against De Paula. You can hear the fans in the background. The 3-2 just missed for ball four. Here to be that breaking ball and could not quite get it to the corner. It is a walk to Cesar, and one of the most dangerous hitters that Sugar Land has in Steve Moss moves in. The time run represented by Cesar at first base. Moss is 1-for-3. The two out toss. Breaking ball to the outside corner, 0-1. The Skeeters, similar to the Blue Crabs, they are fighting. They have scored two runs in this inning alone. The 0-1. Curveball dips outside. Low. One ball and one strike. Moss, is one of his favorite hobbies is to complete the Sunday Times crossword puzzle. He has to figure out this puzzle from De Paula. If he doesn't solve it, De Paula is out of the inning. If he does solve it, he could get his team closer. 1-1. Breaking ball to the outside corner. 1-2.
Come on, Bluefish fans. I want to hear you. Come on, let's go.
Alterations between fastball and breaking ball. You have the slider, too. Not too much of that today. As De Paula steps off the rubber, twists his head towards first, but Cesar is there. Runner goes, a 1-2, swung on and missed, strike three. Moss goes down on high cheese. He is angry at himself as he removes his gloves and is about to go back to the field. The Bluefish give up two runs, but the tying run did not score as was stranded at first base. Two runners left on, end of 7.5. The Bluefish lead 7-5. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Miller Lite. We know there's only one thing baseball fans love as much as great Pilsner taste, and that's rooting for the home team. Because home is way better than away. Away is not where the heart is. Bringing away the bacon? Why? Bacon is delicious. Away is where you hang your hat? You should be hung up by your underpanties. So why root for the away team when you can root for the home team? With a great Pilsner taste of Miller Lite. Triple hops brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Come and join the Bluefish for a playoff push in 2012. The Bluefish have great options from picnics and birthday parties to harbor club outings and sweet leases. Invite your friends, family, or co-workers out to the ballpark for an exciting night of affordable family fun. Kids celebrating a birthday party at the ballpark will get an autographed baseball, a visit from BB the Bluefish, and much, much more, including a chance to compete in the best on-field promotions Connecticut has to offer. Don't miss out on the final home games of the regular season. Book your outing with the Bluefish today. Call 203-345-4800 to schedule an unforgettable day at the ballpark and Harbor Yard during the 15th anniversary season. Or go to BridgeportBluefish.com. Bridgeport Bluefish Baseball. Get hooked.
Jimmy Rollins talks about the Baseball Hall of Fame.
Just being in the same place that all these great ball players, you know, reside at now, their career, you go find their stats, their jerseys, their helmets, their cleats, and have something of mine, that is something that anybody that goes to the Hall of Fame can see.
Preserving history, honoring excellence, connecting generations. At the National Baseball Hall of Fame and Museum in Cooperstown, New York. Connect with Cooperstown at baseballhall.org.
This call to the bullpen is presented by Prudential Annuities. Prudential Annuities going to bat for our community. We do apologize. We do need to correct. It is Sean Morgan at the hill. That's the call to the bullpen. So Sean Morgan's into the game now, but beforehand it was not angling to the right. Three balls, two strikes. Major League scoreboard update courtesy of ESPN.com. And the Yankees, last check, were not in good shape, but they have crept closer. It's 5-4. Yankees trailing the Rays. Baltimore plays at Oakland tonight. Determine first place in the American League East, potentially. Mets 6, Brewers 2 in the top of the 6th. Boston a 5-4 lead against Toronto, top of the 8th. We'll get to the rest of the finals later, as far as baseball goes, because none of the others are local games. 3-2 is chased, strike 3. Simmons strikes out for the second time. He's 2-for-4. Luis Rodriguez is the next batter due up. One NFL game last night, 23-10 Green Bay over Chicago. There are no Saturday games. Sunday, NFL time. NCAA football tonight. There is one game taking place, but not in the top 25. Washington State 21 and UNLV 7. Second quarter from Vegas. All the ranked games taking place tomorrow. The NHL Players Association, as the next toss is upstairs, one ball, no strikes, denied an injunction, and it appears as if the NHL's headed for another lockout. The 1-0. Ground ball towards the middle. It skates by for a base hit. It went past the leg as Morgan may have tried to kick it to himself. Just lifted his leg at the last moment. Rodriguez, 2-for-4 tonight. Springs Luis Figueroa. Darrell Revis of the Jets is expected to sit down. Troy Polamalu and James Harrison also questionable for Sunday. Pittsburgh and the Jets. Giants will play Tampa Bay this weekend. Figueroa batting from the left sideline. Drive, two hops, snared by Hagen. He throws the second one onto first, double play to retire the side. One base hit, but the 4-6-3 eliminates any base runners. The Bluefish shift to the top of the ninth. Rami Lewis time when we return on BridgeportBluefish.com as the closer, the new closer for the Bluefish, is about to take his command on the mound. 7-5, end of 8. We'll be right back.
Sizzling succulent filet mignon, scrumptious salmon Florentine, savory twin grilled pork chops. Getting hungry? Your table awaits at the Park City Grill, Fairfield County's elegant new dining spot in the beautifully renovated Bridgeport Holiday Inn. Comfortable, warm, and inviting, Park City Grill offers a world-class dining experience at reasonable prices. Come to the Park City Grill, 1070 Main Street in the Bridgeport Holiday Inn. Take I-95 exit 27A to exit 2. Plenty of free, secure parking.
Baseball legend Henry Aaron reflects on his Hall of Fame legacy.
I think that since I played for the public, they need to share what I did in my life as far as baseball. It's the proudest moment of my life to give everything to the Hall of Fame. I often tell people they need to get and see it. There is no other building in the world like the Hall of Fame in baseball.
Celebrate the game. Celebrate the legacy. Connect with Cooperstown at baseballhall.org. Mike Piazza talks about the Baseball Hall of Fame.
It just connects you with the history of the game and the tradition of this game and how important this game is to the fabric of society. It's something I used to bond with my father, and I will always, and I love to sort of teach my kids the history of baseball.
Preserving history, honoring excellence, connecting generations. Connect with Cooperstown at baseballhall.org. Jimmy Rollins talks about the baseball.
This call to the bullpen, presented by Prudential Annuities. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for our community. Rami Lewis is in the game. Second straight day that the southpaw has been in. An unearned run yesterday, two hits, but picked up his save. And he's looking for save number five. 50 innings. 2.16 ERA, 3-1 record. An opponent's hitting 269 against him, but the big number, the walks. 11 walks in 50 innings. That's pretty good for anyone, let alone the closer of the team who's been sprayed into a number of roles. And you notice the song transition to Sad But True in the background. But Lewis, not a sad case at all. Excellent pitcher. Left-hander was with the Toronto Blue Jays last year. Now is in the Bluefish bullpen as he must take on Josh Presley, Aaron Bates, and Bubba Bell. Southern Maryland scored a run yesterday in the ninth inning, cut the deficit to one, but Lewis was able to retire the final batter of the night. This time around, it's Presley. Nobody out. Two hits, four ABs. First pitch, fastball low. One ball, no strikes. Every one of these players is exhausted. They have some nicks, injuries, pains. Nobody goes unscathed. The 1-0. Fastball outside, two balls and no strikes. A lefty-lefty situation. Lewis is ready. The pitch is chopped on the ground to the right side. Figueroa handles on the high hop and throws to first. Scooped up by Lopez, one away. It is a 4-3 for Presley. Lewis always is throwing the football, running his sprints. He has his routine. Every player has their routine. And Lewis will run a couple of back and forths from the chalk all the way to the warning track to try to get his stamina up there for the one inning that he's going to pitch during a game, or even two innings that he's going to pitch during a game. It's different for every pitcher. There's some, like Gilbert De La Vara, who never need to run. They always throw. They seem to have rubber arms. One out, toss on the outside corner, 0-1. And then there are others like Matt Pike, who run 2.5 miles, and Jorge Julio, who do the same. Even though he's on the inactive list, Julio. Still, they were working out 2.5 mile runs every day. Brad Thompson the same way. take it so mildly. The 0-1 is served out of play to the right side, nearly caught by one of the fans. In the back row, no balls and two strikes. The Bluefish with a victory would move to 31-29. The Skeeters with a loss, 31-30. And no movement on the Lancaster front, although Tommy Everidge is up with runners at first and second for the Barnstormers. The 0-2, fastball, trickles low, one ball and two strikes. Somerset giving York a hard time tonight, but Revolution prevail over the Patriots 6-5, and that just about does it for Somerset. Next pitch, swung on and missed, strike three. Aaron Bates goes down, 2-for-5 for Bates. Bubba Bell digs in.
And make some noise.
Somerset 10.5 back of Lancaster with 9 to play. That's not happening. They're eliminated from there. And the Patriots are now 9 back of York with 9 to play. York the same. York will clinch a playoff spot with a victory tomorrow. The 2-out pitch is on the outside corner, 0-1. And with that wild card clinch, York can rest some of their pitchers and get their assignments ready, possibly for Lancaster. The pitch is grounded over the third. Boyer on the backhand, rifles across, scooped up by Lopez. He's gone. The ball game is over, and the Bluefish win by a score of 7-5. Beautiful throw by Boyer on the corral, and then an even better scoop on the other side by Lopez. The post game show comes to you right after the break on BridgeportBluefish.com.
You call this little ditty America's pastime. Summer's here and it feels pretty nice. Baseball and hot dogs and refreshment on ice. Some games are early, some are at night. But there's always a beer man with ice cold Coors Light. He's the most reliable player in the game. All it takes is calling his name, so even if your team doesn't hit any dingers, you'll have Frost Brewed Refreshment at the tips of your fingers. Thank you.
Frost Brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. With great beer comes great responsibility.
Behind everything you're searching for is something you're actually looking for. When you flip through the real yellow pages for a plumber, you're actually looking to reclaim your home from a renegade faucet. It's not just getting directions to a tailor with YP.com. It's looking your best for an interview. And it's more than finding a mechanic with YP.com on your mobile. It's getting your road trip back on track. Whatever it might be, there are more ways to search and more ways to find exactly what you're looking for with the real yellow pages, YP.com, and YP.com on your mobile. Only from AT&T. Behind everything you're searching for is something you're actually looking for. When you search with the real yellow pages, you get more than a contractor. You get a whole new curb appeal. It's not just getting directions to a dry cleaner with YP.com. It's rescuing an old favorite from the back of the closet. And it's more than finding a locksmith with YP.com on your mobile. It's getting to sleep in your own bed. Whatever it might be, there are more ways to search and more ways to find exactly what you're looking for with the real yellow pages, YP.com, and YP.com on your mobile, only from AT&T.
Bluefish baseball is back. Perry Miles with you as the Bluefish. They win 7-5 tonight. Let's take a look at the scoring summary from tonight's action. It all began with the Skeeters in the first inning. An RBI single by Josh Presley with runners at first and second base. Sugar Land took a 2-0 lead by adding one more on an RBI single from Aaron Bates. The Bluefish then scored 7 of the next 8 runs. The Bluefish scored the first on a solo drive from Prentice Redmond. It was his 17th of the year. Then, Sugar Land responded. RBI single, Bubba Bell, 3-1. Grand slam home run, Prentice Redmond, in the fifth inning to open it up a 5-3 lead for the Bluefish, and they did not trail after that point. Bridgeport scored 2 more runs in the sixth inning. RBI single by Figueroa, RBI fielder's choice Brad Boyer. The Skeeters scored two in the eighth of Jesse English. RBI three unassisted for Castro, and also an RBI from Octavio Martinez. And the Bluefish wound up winning by a score of 7-5. Let's take a quick look at the box score today. A hit for Ramos, four hits and two runs for Castro. A hit for Cesar, nothing for Ross. Two hits and a ribby. Presley, Bates, two hits, a run and a ribby. Bell, three hits, a run and a ribby. Hagan, a hit, a run, and a run driven in by Martinez. 5-15-0 for Sugar Land. 7-13-0 for Bridgeport. Hit and run for Jones. Two hits and a run for Rogers. Redmond, two hits, two runs, and five. RBI, Otanya's ahead. Lopez with nothing. Two hits for Simmons, Rodriguez, and Figueroa. Each one of them scored runs. Figueroa with an RBI. Boyer with a hit and a ribby on the day. Ramos is 23rd double. Bates is 6th. Bell is 34th. Otanya's is 5th. Home run from Redmond. He had two. He has 18. Presley with a 73rd ribby. Bates is 24th. Bell is 50th. Martinez is 19th. Redmond had 5. He has 71. Figueroa with 19 now. Boyer 41. Ophelio Castro is caught stealing his second. Sugarland left 11 on base. Bridgeport with 4. Eddie Rogers, well, he turned a couple of double plays today. But the Bluefish, well, it was one double play for the Bluefish, rather, and two double plays for the Skeeters. Jason Lane loses, 8-5 on the year. 6 innings of 7 run, 12 hit, 4 strikeout baseball. Richardson with an inning and a walk. Morgan an inning and a hit and a walk. And a strikeout, rather, not a walk. Oseguera, 11-6. 6 innings, 3 runs, 12 hits, 3 walks, 3 strikeouts. English an inning and a third with 3 hits, 2 runs, 3 strikeouts. Julio DePaula, 2/3, a walk and a strikeout. Rami Lewis's 5th save, an inning and a strikeout. A total of 13 strikeouts today, thrown by both, by each, well, combined. Ramos with 1, Moss with 3, Presley with 1, Bates 2. Bell contributed 1 strikeout, Rogers with a couple. Otanya's 1, Simmons with 2. 5 walks, Cesar with 1, Moss a couple, Hagan with 1, Redmond with 1. Time of the game, 2 hours and 57 minutes at the ballpark at Harbor Yard in front of this crowd. The Bluefish win by a score of 7-5. When the postgame show continues, we'll close it out with the Atlantic League scores, also the big league scores, and then tell you what to expect tomorrow. Stay tuned. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
At Miller Lite, we believe that sharing a pitcher of our great-tasting draft beer will bring friends together for a good time. And good is way better than bad. No one reminisces about the bad old days. If your guess is as bad as mine, then we're a couple of idiot faces. So far, so bad? Turn that frown upside down, grumpy pants. So why have a bad time when you could have a good time with a pitcher of Miller Lite draft beer? Triple hops brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. At Miller Lite, we don't just make a light beer with average taste. We make one with great Pilsner taste. And there's a big difference between great and average. Nobody strives to achieve averageness. Exploring the average outdoors? Have fun in your backyard, Magellan. If that book was called Average Expectations, it wouldn't be worth Dickens. Average minds don't think alike. They don't think, period. So why settle for average taste when you can have great Pilsner taste? Triple hops brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Come and join the Bluefish for a playoff push in 2012. The Bluefish have great options from picnics and birthday parties to harbor club outings and suite leases. Invite your friends, family, or coworkers out to the ballpark for an exciting night of affordable family fun. Kids celebrating a birthday party at the ballpark, they get an autographed baseball, a visit from BB the Bluefish, and much, much more, including a chance to compete in the best on-field promotions Connecticut has to offer. Don't miss out on the final home game of the regular season. Book your outing with the Bluefish today. Call 203-345-4800 to schedule an unforgettable day at the ballpark in Harbor Yard during the 15th anniversary season, or go to BridgeportBluefish.com. Bridgeport Bluefish Baseball. Get hooked.
You know what sounds really great for lunch? Breakfast. And what would be awesome for dinner? Breakfast. See, there's no better choice for breakfast, lunch, or dinner than Chips. Chips Family Restaurants in Orange and Fairfield. Known far and wide for extreme acts of outrageous pancakery, Chips also has a lunch and dinner menu that'll have you ditching the drive-thru and saying bye-bye brown bag. A full lunch and dinner menu of outrageously delicious sandwiches, salads, steaks, reasonably priced. And, of course, Chips' famous pancakes for any meal, any day. For breakfast, lunch, or dinner, flip it to Chips on the Post Road in Orange and in Fairfield at the intersection of Black Rock Turnpike and Tunxas Hill Cutoff. Voted best in Connecticut by the readers of Connecticut Magazine for extreme acts of outrageous pancakery all day long.
The best way to brighten up your home is to do just that. Brighten it up. To illuminate and decorate. The exciting lighting ideas come from Valley Lighting and Home Decor. Your home becomes your showplace when you let it shine with designer lighting so distinctive it is clearly a work of art. Valley Lighting and Home Decor is set to bedazzle you with glittering crystal chandeliers and lamps. Treasures abound in unique home accents, special touches, just the right things to bring your whole decor together. Because your home is not just what's inside the four walls, brighten up your garden, your deck, and your pool area with outdoor landscape lighting. This is the season to invigorate, radiate, celebrate, rejuvenate. The brightest ideas begin here at Connecticut's largest lighting and home decor showplace. Illuminate and decorate at Valley Lighting and Home Decor on Chestnut Street in Ansonia, just a minute off Route 8, Exit 16.
Bluefish Broadcast Network is back for the postgame show on BridgeportBluefish.com. Bridgeport wins by a score of 7-5. Let's take a look at the Southern Maryland Lancaster update. It's the top of the ninth inning from Lancaster, 4-0, Southern Maryland on top, as the rally was quashed by Kevin Hart, who entered the game for Charlie Manning. And let's take a look at the rest of the scores from around the Atlantic League, courtesy of PointStreet.com and AtlanticLeague.com. York takes care of Somerset, 6-5. Long Island defeats Camden, 8-5. That is it. And Somerset, with one more loss, has been eliminated from postseason play. The Skeeters, with a Lancaster victory, would be their tragic number would be one. But right now it's at two, as the Bluefish won tonight by a score of 7-5. The Bluefish, if they do not get a loss from Southern Maryland, their tragic number is much higher than that. Still a long way to go. But the Bluefish, they don't care about that. They need to take care of their own business.
Next we have,
in Major League Baseball,
from the Rocky Hill,
Yankees,
Kansas,
trailing the Rays 5-4, top of the ninth inning, runner at second. The Mets 7, the Brewers 2 in the bottom of the sixth, runners at first and second. Boston, Toronto tied at 5 in the bottom of the eighth inning. Bottom of the ninth inning from Atlanta, 2-1. Braves on top of the Nationals, runners at first and second. Kansas City, a 6-5 lead on the Angels. Top of the seventh, with bases loaded. White Sox, a grand slam lead, 4-0 over Minnesota. Top of the seventh, runner at second. Texas 2 and Seattle 1, top of the 7th. Philadelphia 7, Houston 4 in the top of the 7th. Bottom of the 2nd from Arizona. No score between San Francisco and Arizona. Runners at 2nd and 3rd. Baltimore and Oakland, top of the 2nd. Scoreless. Colorado 5 and San Diego. Gusek in the middle of the 1st. St. Louis and the L.A. Dodgers in the bottom of the 1st. No score. Rest of the scores are Final Cubs 7, Pittsburgh Pirates 4. The Tigers blanket the Indians 4-0. Miami shuts down Cincinnati 4-0. In NFL play last night, Green Bay 23 and the Chicago Bears 10. And the rest of the games taking place on Sunday or Monday. In NCAA football, Washington State 28 and UNLV 17. About 10 minutes gone by in the second quarter. The NHLPA has been denied the injunction, and it appears as if the players are going to be locked out by the owners, and it appears that Dallas wants to extend Tony Romo, their quarterback, and Darrell Revis appears to be on his way to sitting as a result of the head injury he suffered, a mild concussion. Paul Malo and Harrison Ify for Sunday's tilt between the Jets and the Steelers. We thank you for tuning in to Bluefish Broadcast Network tonight. For more information about Bluefish Baseball, go to the website, bridgeportbluefish.com. You can send me an email, perrym86@gmail.com, or you can follow me on Twitter, just me, B. Miles. Just me, B. Miles. The Bluefish win by a score of 7-5 as the fireworks extravaganza takes place right now, presented by Sabrent. And the Bluefish won tonight. They showed some fireworks tonight. The Bluefish improved to 62 wins and 68 losses, are 31-29 in the second half of play. The Sugar Land Skeeters, they fall 31-30 in second half play. And overall, Sugar Land is 59-71, actually 60-71 on the season. The Bluefish took on the Skeeters and were able to come away with the victory. The Bluefish improved to 30-33 at home. They are 9-5 in the month of September, 62-68 overall. They are officially 8-9 against Sugarland and on a 4-3 record against the Skeeters at the ballpark at Harbor Yard against Sugarland. Thank you for tuning in. 1:05 first pitch tomorrow. 12:05 the gates will open. 12:45 for the pregame show on BridgeportBluefish.com. Prostate Cancer Awareness Day and NFL, and also WPLR Day. A chance to meet Chaz and AJ from WPLR, the radio station, as the fireworks taking place in the background. The Bluefish 7 and the Skeeters 5. Have a wonderful night, folks. Ta-da for now. We'll see you later from the ballpark at Harbor Yard. 7-5, the final. See you tomorrow at bright and early at 12:45.